down on courtside, you know what time it is. It's
sports plus life, sports plus life, huh?
Ringside or front court or field pass, we ballin' no. Knuckle up or buckle up, I tell it like it is when I'm on my show. Home run, slam dunk, knockout, or gossip dough.
Sports plus life,
yeah.
Sports plus life, huh? Yo, what's up, what's really good? It's your boy Brandon Braveon Towns, host of that show called Sports Plus Life, you feel me? And y'all already know it's going down today, bruh. So guess what? Turn it off, turn it all the way off now. Yeah, cut, print, whatever, all that shit. Okay, time to cut it off. Let's go. Okay, please allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Brandon Braveon Towns, host of that show called Sports Plus Life, that their sports podcast where we talk about all of the necessary topics in sports and all of the necessary topics in life. And I hope that everybody is having a marvelous Monday, a fantastic day. Weather feels good, you know, fall, love it, fall, around to like mid-60s today in the Richmond, VA, but it is Monday, October the 17th, 2000 of the 2-2, we are 2 weeks away from Halloween. Anyway, don't mind me. I'm just being a goofball because that is what I do. But again, I hope everybody has a wonderful and blessed weekend. Twins, I also want to send out my love, definitely my love to my black and gold fam and my fam in general. You know, that's the norm, absolutely, because I love them. And I just hope everybody is doing well, doing great. Special shout out to the E2E building. If you guys are not familiar what that is, listen and take notes. The E2E building is a building where me and my pop, DJ Amp, Wayne Ampy, we just DJ'd there for a baby shower this past Saturday. It used to be the old Verona Library right off of Laburnum Avenue, and these people have bought it, and we DJ'd for the people who own the building, but it's very nice. They've turned it into, very nice. If you have events you want to have there, birthday parties, retirement parties, weddings, or wedding ceremonies, receptions, excuse me, the E2E building stands for Excel to Excellence, and the people are great. The prices are great. You honestly cannot beat the price. You really can't. You cannot beat the price of what they're offering. $500. And you can have the building for the whole day. I was speaking with the owner. His name is Sean. Very cool dude. Very down-to-earth dude. And the building is beautiful. I mean, the setup for the baby shower was absolutely gorgeous. We had a good time. We rocked the party. And them folks party, bro. I'm going to tell you something. When I saw the bartender at a baby shower, I was like, I like that. I really do. But it was great. Great people. Again, the E2E building, Excel to Excellence, right off of Michael Robinson Way, that used to be Wilson Road, right in Verona, directly on the corner of Laburnum Avenue. The E2E building, Excel to Excellence. Yo, you got something you want to do? Check those people out. Google it. Look it up. I'm not putting nobody's phone number out on blast. I'm not going to put nobody's phone number out on blast unless they tell me it's okay. I was giving them free publicity anyway because I absolutely love that space. $500, you got it all day. Anyway, I wanted to get that shout out on and popping, but now it's time to enter the realm of sports. I'm ready. You're ready. We ready. They all ready. Twins, okay? Let's get to it. I am going to start today by talking about the sport of boxing, throwing a little curveball. I know y'all probably saying, oh, Brandon, you're going to go talk about football for the next 2 hours. I could easily do that because it's worth talking about, but y'all know I'm a boxing fan, and Saturday was such a full day of boxing. I've never seen a day of boxing this full with significant fights. Let me start from the beginning. Clarissa Shields, that chick right there ain't nothing but the truth, as she for the second time won the undisputed middleweight championship of the world by defeating Savannah Marshall in London, England by unanimous decision. This was a very good fight. Up and down fight. I thought the judges' scorecards were absolutely fair. I watched that fight. I couldn't watch it when it happened because I was DJing, but I was able to catch it the next day on YouTube. The judges had Clarissa Shields winning 97-93, 96-94, 96-94, and it was very deserving. It was a good fight, good hard fight. Yo, these women have been getting it in this year in the sport of boxing. I can't even front. To me, the fight of the year still was that Katie Taylor fight that happened earlier this year. That was still, to me, the best fight, man, woman. I don't give a damn. But later on that night, Devin Haney in the rematch with George Kambosos. You know what? I really had no interest in this fight because the first fight that they fought in June was so one-sided. It was so lopsided. Devin Haney just out. He put on a boxing lesson, and Kambosos, who it was in his home turf of Australia, he was the undisputed champion, and Devin Haney handled his business much of the same Saturday night. Now Kambosos came out a little aggressive. He was moving all different angles, making it hard for Devin Haney to time him. But that lasted about two rounds. By the end of that fight, both fighters were cut. But by the end of the fight, Kambosos looked like he got hit by a Mack truck. I mean, Devin Haney did his thing. It's time to see Devin Haney fight either Lomachenko. I would love to see him fight Tank Davis. I would. That's the fight that I've actually been looking for the last 3 years. And Haney's a young guy. He's still 23. He turns 24 next month. But he put on a clinic. When he found a home for that 1-2, for that overhand right, he just started shooting it at Kambosos like a laser. He did his thing. Shout out to Devin Haney, American undisputed champion. And then to the fight that was on Fox pay-per-view, the return of the Bronze Bomber. Deontay Wilder got back to his winning ways the first time he has actually won a fight since 2018, because his last three have been against Tyson Fury. And when he ain't fighting Tyson Fury, he looks unstoppable. Not much of boxing technique. He scored a first round knockout over Robert Helaeus. When that fight first started and I saw the way Helaeus came out, he was a big guy, big dude, a little taller than Deontay, damn near about the size of Tyson Fury. But when I saw how slow footed he was, when I saw how wide open he was, I was telling my cousin, I said, he's getting knocked out inside of three rounds. And my cousin was like, for real? I said, inside of three rounds. And the first hard punch Deontay Wilder landed, which he was coming off of his back foot, leaned up against the ropes, planted Helaeus right on his face. Helaeus dropped like a bad habit, and then his body went stiff like he was in a casket. It was over. It was done. Bomb squad, Deontay Wilder. Still, I think we'll give it to anybody in the heavyweight division, as long as their name ain't Tyson Fury, because Tyson Fury is the only one who gets up from those punches. Okay, so... That is the review in boxing. Absolutely awesome. More great fights coming up. But boxing is fucking with me now because I haven't seen the done deal between Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence. That's what we want, damn it. Give it to us. I mean, boxing stay getting on my nerves with that bullshit. But anyway, let's go to football. It is time to go to football now. Okay, let's have the review for the week in football. Obviously, the Broncos and the Chargers play tonight. Well, not looking forward to that because I think my Broncos are going to take an L boogie. But let's go back to Thursday night and that awesome must-see game between the Washington Commanders and the Chicago Bears. The Commanders won in a shootout, a whopping score of 12-7. And the Bears lost in the most Chicago Bears way. Justin Fields on fourth and goal threw it to Darnell Mooney. Looked like he had a catch for a touchdown, bobbles it, and he gets stopped at the inch line. Commanders win. On a week where really you were talking about the shit that was going on with Daniel Snyder more than the football game, at least they got the W. But Ron Rivera really needs to chill out because he's coming on there with massive attitudes talking about trying to walk back his Carson Wentz comments. Bro, when somebody asks you a direct question about why do you think the other teams in the NFC are better than yours, you said the quarterback. So now you're mad at the media because you're getting quoted on it? Chill out, dude. Justin Fields, I see the upside, but God, you need weapons. You do. Now, on the Sunday's games, the Atlanta Falcons are better than we thought they were going to be this season. They are. They beat the San Francisco 49ers 28-14 in the ATL, in the dirty, dirty South, y'all. And the Falcons are 3-3. The Falcons are 3-3. They are a bullshit roughing the passer call away from possibly being 4-2. They got robbed last week. They took care of business today. And I thought the 49ers were going to start to run away with this division or at least put a little bit of separation. When Jimmy Garoppolo throws for over 300 yards or near 300 yards, usually good things don't always happen. I still remember the Saints game from 2019. But big ups to the Falcons, man. They doing their thing. On to Cleveland. I think I'm almost at that point where I'm going to stop picking the Cleveland Browns to win games. And the New England Patriots, yo, Bill Belichick, this Bailey Zappi guy, you might have found your guy instead of Mac Jones. Who? Mac Jones. Who? Mac Jones. Bailey Zappi did his thing, throwing for over 300 yards. Bill Belichick moves into second all-time in wins with that victory. The Patriots spanked the Browns 38-15. Upset special, and Lambeau Field. God damn it, the New York Jets are 4-2. Robert Saleh said before the season, I'm keeping receipts on all you bitches who keep on throwing salt and throwing shade on my football team. The New York Jets didn't just beat the Green Bay Packers in Green Bay. They dominated the Green Bay Packers. I'm talking about physically the whole nine yards. 27-10, the New York football Jets are 4-2. Let's go right to the same team in the same state. The New York football Giants beat the Baltimore Ravens. They are now 5-1. I mean, what the hell is going on with football in New York? What a time to be a football fan in New York. I'm not just talking about Jets and Giants. I'm talking about the Buffalo Bills as well. The New York Giants came back from a double-digit fourth-quarter deficit again for the second week in a row to defeat the Baltimore Ravens 24-20. Coincidentally enough, the Baltimore Ravens blew another double-digit fourth-quarter lead to fall to 3-3. Each of the Ravens' losses, they have blown fourth-quarter leads. Come on, Lamar Jackson. Get your shit together, bruh. You messing up your money, turning the ball over in your last two possessions. But if you're a New York Giants fan, you've got to be thrilled. Brian Daboll is clearly right, and at least right now, looks like the right man for the job. This is the first game where I actually watched Daniel Jones, and I was like, I see it. Because there was a couple of bullets he put in there. A couple of them were dropped. I mean, if you're Giants receivers, you better step the hell up. I'm seeing him rebuild his rapport with Darius Slayton, but you better step the hell up because Daniel Jones right now is getting the job done. Saquon Barkley, like Sean predicted, he is running like a man with a plan, scored the game-winning touchdown, coming off of a Lamar Jackson interception. The New York Giants are 5-1. The New York Jets are 4-2. What the hell is going on with football in the Empire State? I will be damned. Okay, moving on. I think I may have oversold the Jacksonville Jaguars. They have lost their second consecutive game. They lost to the Indianapolis Colts. I think I may have undersold the Colts. We were ready to be done with the Colts quickly. That's how overreaction gets started. We overreact to everything week after week in football. The Colts are 3-2-1. They're in first place. Matt Ryan had a day, throwing for damn near 400 yards, and the Colts beat the Jaguars 34-27 in a very entertaining game. The Minnesota Vikings went to the Miami Dolphins. Remember when Miami was 3-0? Damn, that seemed like a long time ago. They were my sleeper team. They were Sean's sleeper team. They were Tony's sleeper team in the AFC. Damn, that was a long. Now, I know they're dealing with quarterback issues. Teddy Bridgewater started as the backup, ended up coming in. But the Minnesota Vikings are 5-1, you guys. The Minnesota Vikings are 5-1 and looking like they have a comfortable lead on that division now with Green Bay, because not only do they have a two-game lead over the Packers, remember they beat Green Bay week one. Food for thought. In New Orleans in the NO, the Cincinnati Bengals. I said this was going to happen. They defeated the New Orleans Saints 30-26. Joe Burrow and Ja'Marr Chase returned to the state where they won a national championship in 2019 and connected with the game-winning 60-yard touchdown. Ja'Marr Chase, that is a bad mamma jamma. Joe Burrow, I have him starting now in my fantasy team over Russell Wilson. I'm sorry. I just had to do what I had to do. The Bengals improved to 3-3 with a 30-26 win. Upset of the day. The Pittsburgh Steelers, who we were laughing at a week ago, beat Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers 20-18. Kenny Pickett gets concussed. No problem. Let's throw in, wait, Mitchell Trubisky? I mean, I'm just joking. But look, Tom Brady throwing bitch fits, chewing out his offensive lineman, and everybody always wants to make an excuse. Well, Tom Brady is going through things. I don't care. Take your old ass home. You know what? Because now his wife is left, filing for divorce. You deserve to get divorced. You deserve for her to divorce you, you selfish motherfucker.
What's wrong with you?
You can call this Brady hate or whatever. I don't care. Dude, you're 45 years old. You have nothing left to prove in the NFL. You've won more Super Bowls than anybody. You have every passing record known to man. Are your kids that bad? I mean, seriously. Are your kids that bad? Take your ass home. That's all your wife wants is her husband. But your selfish ass, and that's what I'm calling you, your selfish ass has putting your hand underneath a nutsack and more important than your wife and your family. Your kids didn't ask to be here. Your wife has a career too that subsequently makes more money than you. Nobody wants to see you pitching a bitch fit over to your offensive lineman. Why don't you pitch a bitch fit at home? Man, I'm telling you, when Tom Brady finally do retire, he's going to be a miserable motherfucker. But right now, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers fans should be miserable right now. You lost to the Steelers. They're 3-3. Late games. The Los Angeles Rams, they just don't look right. They won yesterday against... They won yesterday against the Carolina Panthers 24-10. But this ain't the Ram team that I saw last year. They won. Bounced back. Good for you. So, incidentally, Steve Wilks, who is the new acting head coach since Matt Rhule got fired... He kicked Robbie Anderson, receiver Robbie Anderson, out the game because of conduct detrimental to the team. What happens today? Robbie Anderson just got traded to the Arizona Cardinals. Speaking of the Cardinals, they lost yesterday too. Holy Geno Smith, Batman. The Seattle Seahawks are 19 and won the game 19-9 over the Cardinals. And that's crazy because Seattle's defense was giving up 30 points a game. They only gave up 9 to Kyler Murray. I know you just gave Cliff Kingsbury a contract extension. You might want to rethink that. Geno Smith. You talking about quarterbacks who are having career resurrections. Let's look at Marcus Mariota. Let's look at Geno Smith. Out here doing his thing, the Seattle Seahawks are 3-3. Game of the day, perhaps AFC Championship preview between the Buffalo Bills and the Kansas City Chiefs. Buffalo goes into Kansas City. A Josh Allen late touchdown pass to Dawson Knox and an interception thrown by Patrick Mahomes. And the Buffalo Bills walk out of KC with a victory. They're now 5-1. That's all well and good for Buffalo. Do it in the playoffs. But I will say this. This is why you got Von Miller. Because Von Miller had a closer sack the drive before. Buffalo went to take the lead. And he splits a double team that makes Patrick Mahomes roll right though when he doesn't want to. Thus the interception. Von Miller is that dude, I'm telling you right now, I don't give a fuck. You can see, anybody who says that Aaron Donald is better than Von Miller, kill yourself. Kill yourself. Because the Rams don't have that Super Bowl last year if Von Miller isn't there. I don't give a damn what you say. So Buffalo goes to 5-1. The Chiefs fall to 4-2. At night, in the nighttime, the Sunday night game, guess what happened? The Eagles versus the Cowboys. Let me tell you what happened. The Philadelphia motherfucking Eagles. You hear that Rocky music? They handled their business on them old bitch-ass Cowboys. They beat them 26-17. Jalen Hurts connected with A.J. Brown for a touchdown. Miles Sanders had a touchdown. The Philadelphia Eagles defense. All you were hearing about all last week was Dallas defense this, Dallas defense that. I said, yo, the Eagles defense ain't no chopped liver. They intercepted Cooper Rush 3 times, and I don't want to hear nothing from no damn Cowboy fans about you beat our backup quarterback. Y'all was riding Cooper Rush's dick for the last 4 weeks when he won y'all 4 games. Props to him. He did what he had to do as a backup quarterback. But when you took up, when you took a step up in competition, you got your ass handed to you. I understand you cut a 17-point lead to 3, but here's the bottom line with me. Bitch, you lost. You lost, okay? Fly, Eagles, fly. Bird Gang, the only undefeated team left in the NFL are the Philadelphia Eagles sitting at 6-0. Lane Johnson had to leave with a concussion. That's when the game started to turn. Eagles are a running team. That's their best lineman. But nonetheless, the Eagles won 26-17. Jalen Hurts did his thing. A.J. Brown did his thing. Eagles did their thing. They defense did their thing. Big play Slay, okay? Did his thug thiggity, okay? So 6-0 Bird Gang going into the bye week. Perfect time for the bye week. I can't wait to have Sean on here. I can't wait to have Marquise on here because they're Eagles fans, and I know they happy as hell. I'm a Bronco fan, but y'all know if I had a secondary, it's them goddamn Philadelphia Eagles. Fly, Eagle, fly. I love Bird Gang. And what is the motto of this show? Fuck the Dallas Cowboys.
Biatch.
Fuck them. Fuck them up against the wall with handcuffs on and crazy glue on their lips. That's what you do. And not only did Dallas lose the game, they fell to third place. Why? Because the New York Football Giants are 5-1. Got to look at the NFC East as the most powerful division right now in football. Philly 6-0. Giants 5-1. Dallas 4-2. It is realistic that we could see 3 teams from the NFC East make the playoffs because everybody else in the NFC is weak. I'm talking about 3-3 teams. I mean, look at it. Think about it. Outside of the Minnesota Vikings, what are the Packers? 3-3. Tampa Bay, 3-3. Atlanta, 3-3 on the positive side. You got the Rams, 3-3. You got the Seahawks, 3-3 on the positive side. You got the 49ers, 3-3. So it's not out of the realm of possibility that the Dallas Cowboys, Eagles, and Giants could all be in the playoffs because, again, the NFC East looks so weak. But, bottom line is, Bird Gang got that dub. They got that W. They sit alone in first place in the NFC East. They sit alone as the only undefeated team in the NFL. How do you like that now? Nick Sirianni, you're doing your thing. Jalen Hurts, you're doing your thing. Darius Slay, you're doing your thing. That defense, Fletcher Cox, the Jordan Davis from Georgia, they are doing their thing. Now, Dak Prescott is saying that he's coming back against the Lions. I mean, if you want to pick a horrible defense to come back against, that's the one. That's the team to do it. That's the team to do it against. So, yeah, very good day. Very good day. Look, when I see the Cowboys lose and I see Tom Brady lose, me likey that Sunday, okay? And first up on this prediction Monday, I got Big C Calvin. What up, bro?
What's up, man?
Man, I wish you guys had heard him when I first called him. As soon as he answered the phone, I said, "What up, bro?" He said, "Oh Lord, why did you say that, brother?"
I just think I don't have no fucking luck with these games, man. I have no fucking luck with football right now. And all we lost to the fucking Pittsburgh. But you know what? I guess that's karma for us. We supposed to lost last week. And we lost last week when we should have lost. We might have been mad enough to do what we had to do today. So, I mean, do what we had to do yesterday. Because that was some bullshit. Like, I don't know what the fuck was going on with that shit. And, like, the powers that be was trying so hard for me to goddamn buy red zone just so I can, because I couldn't find no clips of my game at all, nowhere. They was trying. I was like, man, this is some bullshit. But I don't know. I just ain't picking these things right as me.
But you didn't have a bad day. You know, you got 6 right. Like I said, nobody had a great day yesterday. Sean and David took the day. They both got 8. I got 7. You got 6. Yeah. I think Marcus got 6 too. But as far as Tony, Keith, and Aaron, they had bad days, bro. I'm talking about 3 and 4 right. That's it. And you know them Cowboy fans had a real bad day.
Yeah, thank God for Philly. Let me tell you something, man. I felt so bad. It was like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? Like, I felt almost as bad as I did after the NFC Championship. After that, we lost after we lost to the Rams. I was like, what the fuck was that? You know what I'm saying? Then you start going over your mind, like, you know, maybe you deserve to lose that. Well, of course you deserve to lose. You lost. And, you know, you stole one last week. You know what I'm saying? And then So then it's like, oh, shit. We really should be 2-4. Then you're like, oh, shit. So I'm going through all this shit. Then the Cowboys lose. And I feel better now. You know,
have you? I mean, don't everything seem like, don't ever see things seem right with the world when Dallas loses?
It's like you ever see like on like Discovery ID or something? They show like these letters from like people that get or like. You remember see, like, and I'm not trying to, you, like, remember 9-11?
Yeah.
And, like, you see all these documented 9-11, all these text messages from people that's dying or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So when I woke up on Facebook and I was seeing all the, okay, we need to score now. All right, we here now. It went from, we here now, let's go. We the boys to, all right, we need to score. So what the fuck is, come on now. And and it was just, and I'm still watching this shit. You know what I'm saying? It's like, Facebook is haunted. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's haunted. Like, you can see it in detail as it happens. And they go from good to bad to worse. And it was like, they like just to hear these, see these people flee. You know what I'm saying? It was heartbreaking. And I was like, damn.
Well, I'm going to tell you what.
Because I'm going to be honest, too. Like, I feel like, you know what I'm saying? We, in the division, like, I feel like we're going to be all right. You know what I'm saying?
Well, see, here's the thing about it. I mean, it's a couple of divisions that are just, you know, that it's just, it, to me, it's just so weird because I look at y'all division, and I said this earlier, the Atlanta Falcons are a bullshit roughing the passer call away from possibly being 4-2. Then you look at the NFC West, the Rams 3-3, the Niners 3-3, the Seahawks 3-3, but they on the upside. You know what I'm saying? Nobody expected this from Geno Smith. Nobody expected this from Marcus Mariota. The goddamn New York Jets and the Giants are killing it right now.
Well, they are first round picks. And but you know what though too? I called last week. You can call yesterday two things: either Black Sunday or the day of those that are you just show the ones that were promised showed their head. I mean, think about it: Pickett, Trubisky, both first round picks, Zach Wilson. First round pick. Who else? Daniel Jones, first round pick.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know, so you're looking at a glimpse. It's like, it was almost like a glimpse of the near future. The people who had the grip on it is flipping. And the ones that were promised, the ones that were promised, you saw glimpses of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh man, yesterday was a weird day.
It really was, because when I was watching that,
go ahead. I said the only thing that really brought the day, rounded this shit off, was once the fucking Cowboys lost.
Yeah.
The only thing that made it, you know, it's like, what's going on? Oh, okay, all right. We just try it again next week. You know what I'm saying? Because if they would have been the undefeated team, you know what I'm saying? Oh man.
But when I look at the NFC right now, I was talking, I was going on my fuck Dallas rant as I do a fuck Dallas rant better than Stephen A. Smith, better than Shannon Sharp, better than all of them. Them niggas need I shouldn't say them niggas respectfully, because they are educated and accomplished black men who I look up to. Those brothers need to take some notes from me. And if you're talking about pure hatred for the Cowboys, okay, but.
It's not the team, it's the
fans.
Go ahead.
But what I did also say, it's very realistic, at least right now, where you could see three NFC East teams making the playoffs. Because, like I just said to you, everybody else, with the exception of the Minnesota Vikings, every other team of note is sitting at 3-3. You got Philly 6-0, you got the Giants 5-1, you got the Cowboys 4-2. So right now, those are three teams right now that everybody else, with the exception of the Vikings, everybody else is looking up at those three teams. Well, the Vikings are looking up at the Eagles, because the Eagles beat them. They have the head-to-head anyway.
Yeah, what's the Vikings record?
5-1.
Yeah.
Their only loss was to Philly.
Yeah.
But what was your takeaway from your Tampa Bay Bucks, man? That's we all picked Tampa Bay to win that game, so nobody picked Pittsburgh.
That's my point. I couldn't fucking see nothing. I couldn't find nothing on Twitter. Like, I couldn't find shit on Twitter. I couldn't find. They would show no clips of the shit. They keep saying the same fucking clip. I don't know, bro.
You gotta start. You can make your way over here on Sundays, bro. You could have watched the entire game. I could have put it on for you.
Oh, you would have liked that shit, wouldn't you?
The local game, because, you know, I have the red zone on one TV. Then I'll have another game. The other game that I had on was the Ravens and the Giants. And then I started switching over to the Bengals and the Saints because that was a good-ass game, too.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so, I mean, but...
I don't know. I can't answer that because I don't know exactly. I know a lot of shit went wrong, but I don't know exactly what.
Bro, this is one of this is the theme for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers this season. Tom Brady throwing a bitch fit. That's all you see.
Yeah, what?
Tom Brady throwing a bitch fit. I don't, and you know, everybody always want to pacify this old fuck nigga. I don't have nothing against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers organization.
Uh-huh.
Okay, because for the record, I rooted for y'all to crush the Raiders in Super Bowl 37. And you did.
So what is it now? It's the whole Tom Brady.
Yeah, I'm sick of Tom Brady. I don't have anything personal against Tom Brady. I'm just sick and tired of his ass.
And I believe you. I feel you. Because had he not went to us, I'd probably feel the same way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? So I get that. I understand that. But had he had came to Denver, you feel a whole lot different.
Of course. Look. Look.
Perfect lie.
Remember when Peyton Manning came to Denver?
Uh-huh.
I hated Peyton Manning before he came to Denver. I had a genuine hate for Peyton Manning because this son of a bitch would always beat us. I had a genuine disdain for Peyton Manning, but as soon as he signed his name on the dotted line, that became my guy.
Right, okay, right.
That became my guy.
So he was your guy. Like even when it looked like he was on a decline, that was your guy. You defended him. You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
That was your guy. Okay, so that's my take on Brady. So when you win 7 Super Bowls, you can have those little bitch. Because the chances are, you know what the fuck you talking about. You know what I'm saying? You've seen enough good football to know that they're not doing their fucking job. You can just like Jordan told Kobe sometimes. You told Kobe in that fucking All Star game. I can get that call. I did this, that, and the third. That's the same rules apply, baby.
You're talking to
a goat.
Well, Tom Brady might be your goat, goddamn.
They're not out there 21, and they're not out there beating people by 14 points, and he's still on their ass. No, he's trying to keep them in the game.
Tom Brady ain't my goat, goddamn it. I'm going to tell you that right now.
I understand.
This is my thing with Brady. Bro, you have nothing else to prove. Go home.
Uh-huh.
Go home. Now it's public that your wife is leaving your ass. Go home. I'm not saying this because he's Buccaneers quarterback. I'm talking about Tom Brady now, the man. Okay?
Right.
You're being a very selfish person because you have a family at home. You have a wife that has a career as well. A career that, by the way, pays her more money than you.
Y'all make it seem like that y'all make it seem like you got a family at home. Why he not at home? It's a job. Wait a minute. Hold on. What the fuck is
yeah, but you know what? But
it's not like he's out in the plains of Africa chasing Bieber.
But his wife has been asking him to come home for the last 4-5 years. And like, cause I said this 2 years ago on the podcast. I said when Tom Brady actually does retire, he's gonna be a miserable son of a bitch.
And so why you think he out there? And so why you think? Oh, so you just answered your own question. Why you think he?
I get what you're saying as far as I answer my own question. But you're going. You know, you can't play football forever. You have there's a family who needs you more than football needs you.
You can't play forever. You're right.
You can't play. There's once your football. When your football days are over, guess what? Your family's still gonna be there. Your kids are going to be there. I'm telling you, it's going to be a trip 10 years from now when those documentaries come out and you hear Tom Brady's kids say what a fucked up father he's been. While everybody else kisses... I'm serious. While everybody else kisses his dick because of his athletic accomplishments, it's going to be a trip. When them kids come out and say... When them kids come out, everybody going to be like, love Tom Brady. When them kids come out and say, fuck Tom Brady. He won't never there for me.
You act like he be beating on them or something.
But look. Hey, you know what? If he was beating on them, that way, hey, if he was beating on them, he was there.
And it's not like he's doing something he ain't been doing. He's been doing this their whole life.
I understand that. But as you evolve in life.
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you a story. Ben Roethlisberger, the last 2 years, his family needed him. You dig what I'm saying? Russell Wilson, his family need him. You dig what I'm saying? If you can play the shit at a high level, you should be able to play as long as you want. You know what I'm saying? Who are we to judge?
I don't disagree with that. But when your wife is saying, I need you here with me, that should trump it all, because when you make a commitment to a woman, you make a commitment for the rest of your life. You ain't make a commitment to football for the rest of your life, not on the playing field. Retire, you signed a $350-some-odd million contract to commentate football. Go commentate football, bro. You can still be around football for the rest of your life without being on the football field. When your wife says, I need you with me, you made that commitment to her.
Is that what they said? Because from what I heard, they've been beefing for a while anyway.
Well, why do you think? Look, Giselle, look. Ever since the Patriots beat the Falcons in that Super Bowl, Giselle done wanted his ass home. But she put up with it for another couple years. Okay, you beat the Rams. Now you got 6. Bring your ass home. But no, I mean, come on now. I mean, she's a living, breathing flat. She's a living, breathing human being. She won't hurt her husband. I mean, because I understand what you're saying. If Tom Brady can still play at a high level, he should be able to do it as long as he wants. But is his wife wrong for wanting her husband?
No, she's not. But it's not like, oh, God, I got to deal with this for another 6 years. Just 1 or 2 more years. You've been doing it. And see, that's the thing. We only know what we've been told. And what, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not like we know exactly what's going on with people. And we, you know what I'm saying? Like, he might know something about her that we don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like, she might steal or something. Or she might...
what is she going to steal? I'm just saying. What is she going to steal that she can't buy?
Kleptomaniacs steal because they can. It's just sort of getting away with
it. I guess. Okay. Fair enough.
She might get handsy after a couple of wines. A couple of glasses of wine. You know what I'm saying? Something happened, and he was like, look. Let me look.
But how do you know it's not the other way around? Look, Tom Brady drops tidbits of information. He tried to be on that, you know, Jordan, Kobe stuff where we're gonna LeBron stuff where we're gonna drop subtle hints. We're not gonna say exactly what it is. Tom Brady said right before the season started, I'm pretty useless if I'm not throwing a football. He need football more than football need him. I guarantee you that.
So then that lies the answer to your question.
Take your old bitch ass home and be with your family.
If he's useless if he's not throwing the football.
Okay, well then why don't he make himself useful and teach one of his sons how to throw a football? You can be creative with your football skills. Okay, you have a son. You have sons that could. Hey, why not? Go for it.
Some people, they making out the scene like this man is like never there. He's out around the corner or something. He's taking the money. He took the VCR and smoked it, and he's never at home. And man, he's not no absentee father. Don't even try to fake that shit.
Man, look, I'm going to say this. I hope his ass gets stretched out, and then he's going to see what's important.
I've never heard that you have a guy like that when it comes to this.
Yeah,
right.
You were. You actually were. Yeah, you were.
I might have been.
I can name another person that you like that about. Nick Cannon.
Oh, yeah, well, that was personal. I thought you was going to say Jamie Duke.
No. Oh yeah. How do you hate an offensive lineman that much?
But you see, it's because he was so critical. Because he was so critical to. I guess you know how they can say. It's crazy how shit connects. Because he was so critical of everybody that played except Tom Brady. Isn't that funny? Like he would talk shit about everybody, and I can see if you're Michael Irvin or. Steve Smith or Deion Sanders or you know what I'm saying? Somebody who was actually playing the shit and was good at it. You know what I'm saying? And I couldn't Google you in your uniform. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, you know, I found Jamie Dukes on Tecmo Super Bowl, bro.
What the fuck is that? You talking about the video game?
Yes.
He didn't give nobody no type of leeway. Like they were like, he was like terrible at it. You know what I'm saying? Like, unless you were Tom Brady or Peyton Manning, everybody else sucked. So in a league of 32 teams with 53 people, I don't want to do the math that quick, but blah, blah, blah. Them the only two people that's any good. Not just the NFL. These people are good. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Instead of pointing to people's mistakes out of what they could have did, it was like, you would have to, I don't even want to go back down that road. But yeah, I couldn't stand it. I really couldn't stand it. But well, you on here talking like Brady owe you money.
I don't have anything personal against. I really don't have anything personal against Tom Brady. I'm just sick of him. Like, bruh. Like, I am. I'm tired of him. Like, go home and be with your family. Like, go. You have nothing. Because, like, bruh, you have nothing. Like, honestly, when I say I want to see him stretched out, I don't want to see nobody hurt. But God forbid somebody land that one shot on your ass.
It happened. It
felt
like you kind of
hope,
but listen,
it'll
be over soon. It's over with after this. You know what I'm saying? Let's go.
And he's looking like a pretty, and he's looking like, and he's looking like an average quarterback right now.
Oh,
no, I'm being serious. He's looking like an average quarterback.
Yeah.
I mean, you are, what with Bill Parcells, you are what your record says you are. They're 3-3. They're an average team. They're just in the division with a bunch of other average or below average teams.
You right. You absolutely right, man.
Yeah, so let's go ahead and make these picks, bro. So, a Thursday night game, New Orleans at Arizona.
I refuse to take New Orleans.
Okay, I got you.
I refuse. I don't give a fuck who they playing.
Okay, well, Atlanta at Cincinnati. Refuse to say them too?
I'm taking Cincinnati. Because, you know, well, the Burrows, he on my fantasy. So I got.
Yeah, I told you, he's on mine too. He didn't let me down yesterday. I'm undefeated in my fantasy league, too.
You told me to keep him.
Yes, of course.
And you see how shit connect? You told me to keep him, and you told me, oh, no, that don't connect. You told me to trade it, because I had Aaron Rodgers first. You said, get rid of Aaron Rodgers. You told me to take the deal, because I was wanting to trade Aaron Rodgers to my brother, because I know people want him.
Yeah.
He gave me Burrow, and you told me Burrow would get off. Yeah, I know.
How's that working out for you?
Working out pretty damn good.
Exactly, so you need to listen to your boy. Need to listen to your boy. Detroit.
A couple of things that concern Tom Brady. Go ahead.
Oh, Jesus. Okay. I was about to pick Tom Brady, too, on my fantasy team. I'm glad I didn't. Detroit at Dallas.
going Dallas.
Yeah, I know you don't want to, but, you know, Detroit's defense is absolutely awful.
Because they got beat, and Detroit is a perfect,
Detroit has a great offense, but Detroit's defense is terrible. Dak will be back next week.
Yeah.
Detroit's defense is horrible.
It's a perfect back to them to get in the beat the boys again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna mark Dallas down for myself too. As much as I don't want to.
Yeah. And sometimes you gotta throw them a bone. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. Sun shines on the dog's ass every now and again. Everybody gets lucky.
Mm-hmm.
Indianapolis at Tennessee. Remember we were ready to write the Colts and Titans off?
Yeah.
It's a game with first place on the line.
I'm gonna take Indianapolis.
Okay.
Matt Ryan
had a day yesterday, didn't he?
He sure did. I have him on my fantasy too.
Well, you look like a smart man today.
Yeah.
Next game, Green Bay at Washington.
Yeah. Green Bay.
This is the first time that Aaron Rodgers and Matt LaFleur have lost two straight games. That's something.
Oh.
And they lost to the Giants and Jets.
Not so fun, is it, boy?
Tampa Bay at Carolina. Is that a good get-right game for you?
We'll see. I never know. You never know. I said the same thing last week. Petrified. I'm going to take... take Tampa though. Hopefully.
You see, Steve Wilkes kicked Robbie Anderson out of the game, and you see subsequently Robbie Anderson has since been traded. He got traded today to the Cardinals.
Oh, he did. God damn. What are them in Miami trying to prove? Like, what the fuck, man? Huh?
Wait a minute. Who's trying to prove?
Robbie Anderson. Them in Miami. Robbie Anderson. They now have Robbie Anderson, Marquise Brown.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
And two of those are two of the best people in the league.
DeAndre Hopkins comes back next week, too. This week, too.
Yeah, but it's like Miami out in the West. It's the same make and everything.
Yeah. New York Giants at Jacksonville.
I take Jacksonville. Somebody got to show them some love. I refuse to take Jacksonville. Fuck. I'm gonna take them just cause. I mean, I can't do no worse.
Okay. Well, hey, look, shit. If anything that this season has taught us, any given Sunday, bro.
Yeah.
Cleveland at Baltimore. Baltimore has become the king of the blown leads.
Yeah, some ain't working. People are figuring that shit out in the second half. And
yeah.
Yeah.
And with that being said, who you picking?
I was hoping you'd pick. I take Baltimore.
New York Jets, the 4-2 New York Jets at my Denver Broncos.
Hey, Brandon, I'm going to say, I need to figure this. Spend all that time about fucking Tom Brady and what he need to do. Because somebody else on this motherfucking the fucking league need to go home, too. You dig what I'm saying?
I dig what you're saying. You get no disagreements here the way he playing like fly-covered shit.
I don't even want to watch the game. You know what I'm saying?
I don't either, tell you the truth.
I'm going to Jets, man. I'm going to Jets.
Okay. I ain't mad at you, bro. The Jets have won 3 in a row. They're rolling. Houston at the Raiders. Houston at Vegas.
Has the Raiders won a game yet?
They beat us. Ain't that a bitch?
That's the only one they won?
That's the only one they won.
Oh. All that Tom Brady shit. I'm taking fucking... Taking fucking Houston, man.
And you okay? Yeah. Okay. And you wonder why your picks are shitty. That's all I'm gonna say.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, hey.
Okay. Seattle at the Los Angeles Chargers.
It's hard to pick those people. I'll
take
Seattle.
Kansas City at San Francisco Super Bowl rematch.
San Fran defense was looking stellar until yesterday.
Right, exactly. But I think the Falcons are better than what we realize.
I can't pick against the Falcons at home.
You betting you going with Kansas City?
Yeah, I can't go against that Bane's brother, man.
All right. Sunday night football. Awful game. Pittsburgh at Miami.
That's Tua first game back, ain't it?
I don't know if he's going to come back. I don't know. If I was Tua, I wouldn't play again for the rest of the season. That's just me.
That's what I said. I think Pittsburgh, man. Cause he's on week one, he's on game one. Everybody else on game 6. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
You dig what I'm saying?
I really do. And Monday Night Football, Chicago at New England. How the hell does that get scheduled for Monday Night Football?
I guess the powers that be knew Bill Belichick and was gonna have a nice little game or something. I don't know, man. I don't fucking know. That shit, you're right, man. I don't know how the fuck that happened. When I pick against New England, I think New England's done. They pull this fucking white boy out. They gonna get a nigga off the street and he's throw for 500 fucking yards.
Yeah, Bailey Zappi.
What the fuck is that? Who the Bailey's happy. Come on, New England and Chicago. I'm gonna take Bill Belichick, man.
Yeah, man. Okay, Calvin's picks are as follows: Arizona, Cincinnati, Dallas, Indianapolis over Tennessee, Green Bay to bounce back, Tampa Bay to bounce back, Jacksonville to bounce back, Baltimore to bounce back, the Jets to beat my Broncos, Houston over Vegas, Seattle over the Chargers, KC to bounce back over the 49ers, Pittsburgh against Miami, he's picking the Steelers, and the New England Patriots. Does that sound about right?
Yeah, that's about right.
Oh, man. Yo, So just a hypothetical question, my guy. How do you feel about being a groomsman or a best man at anybody's wedding?
I don't know. I never got that term. You know what I'm saying? Best man. Like if I'm getting married and you best man, like, what you marrying me for? You know what I'm saying? I just never got why they call this shit that. You know what I'm saying? I call it something else. You know what I'm saying? Like, best, you know, like, think about it, like, basically, you make her like a fool, like, she almost got it right. You know what I'm saying? Like, the wrong nigga. You know what I'm saying?
You a fool. Man. I can't fuck with you.
I'm just saying. That term ain't never, like, it's contradicts itself. You know? It undermines the bride. You know? She married a nigga. She's married, you know what I'm saying? She's married to the dude with the best, but the best man is beside her. You know what I'm saying? It's just, I don't know. I never got this shit.
I follow you. Groomsman, bro. Okay, so how would you feel about being a groomsman?
I mean, that's what's up. I don't care.
Man, just food for thought, bro. Don't read anything into it. Just food for thought. You know, don't read anything into it, Philly Special. Okay, so anyway. All right, my brother. Well, I'm going to get on here and call my brother. Get his, he's riding high. Sean, he the Eagles fan.
Oh, man, listen. My boss is a Redskins fan. He came down and stuff slapping his arm.
That's because he hate the Cowboys.
Yeah, man. We got a subspecies of Cowboys fan in here.
Oh, that's disgusting. That's disgusting.
Most of them look the same. Even ones I know, almost every 3 out of the 4 Cowboys fans I know are bald. Everybody, you know what I'm saying? 4 of them work here. You know what I'm saying? If you could see who I was thinking, you hear that laughing, right?
Yes.
That's a bald headed Dallas Cowboy. But all right then, man. I'll let you go.
Yeah, man. I'ma hit you up.
All right,
bro. Hey, Calvin, a trip, bro. Never lets me down. Never lets me down. But I mean, hey, motto of the show: fuck them Cowboys. And speaking of fuck them Cowboys, you know I've been waiting for this one. My brother, Sean, what it do?
What it do, shouting? Fuck the
Are you feeling good, sir? You feeling good?
I'm feeling good, feeling great. Every day you beat them stars, bitches. We the boys, huh?
Oh, we ain't played a good defense. We ain't played no shit.
We beat your ass.
Say it again.
I say we beat your ass.
Say it again.
I say we beat your ass.
Beat your ass. Hey, we beat your ass. Bird gang. Look, I'm laughing at my Broncos right now. So to see what Philadelphia did last night, made it a little closer than it needed to be. But you know what bottom line with me is? They won. Bring my heart joy.
Yeah, big
fan. And you know, and then the Cowboys didn't just lose. They didn't just go to second place. They fell to third place. So what was your overall takeaway of the game first of that game, Eagles and Cowboys?
That they can't fuck with us. Rush ain't shit. nah, but then Yeah, like I thought it was going to be, bro. I mean, we were going to expose them, bro. But I didn't want to really say that, you know, not like the Jinx and shit. But yeah, what I expected to happen, they did a great, excellent game plan with Michael Parsons, just allowing him to just be free and just making him run all over the place. I heard them say that they knew he was nursing a groin muscle, so they were just making him run all over the place. That was great game planning against him. Completely took him out of the game. D-Law ain't do nothing. Talk about they ain't played a good defense. Had them frustrated. Them boys ready to fight us at the end. The running game was tough when we needed it to be. We did what we always do, score in the second half. Put the points on the board. Jalen, keep the ball moving. He ain't got to do big numbers. Like, you don't have to do that. You run the ball. He runs the ball, get first downs. Let that defense, man. Shouts out to the defense, boy. That
joint
giving me vibes right there.
Well, hey, I said this all last week. I said everybody keep on talking about Dallas defense acting like Philly defense is chopped liver.
Bro, shouts out to the defense, bro. That secondary dangerous, bro. I didn't even think they were going to be.
They got the best secondary in football right there.
Bro, I try, bro. I mean, seriously, man. You got two shutdown corners.
Two of them.
I'm going to say that they shut down. I ain't saying it. The number's saying it.
Right.
And then you got a safety we picked up and trying. I mean, Gardner, man, I love the energy he
brought. Oh, Gardner Johnson? Absolutely.
Yeah, he's like what Jalen Mills is, but actually good at what he does. You know what I mean? Like Jalen Mills had that energy. I mean, granted, he was on a Super Bowl team. He brought that energy. I like it. But he didn't have the talent that I see that Gardner Johnson has. And that same swag, like, yo, I'm here. That gritty. Like, man, that man hurt his hand, came back, and got a pick with his hand that he just got racked up, boy. That's toughness, boy. You need toughness in this league, boy. And that's the kind of defense that made me like Philadelphia way back in the Dawkins. You know,
Jim Johnson days, bruh.
Yeah.
Troy Vincent and Bobby Taylor, bruh.
Absolutely, boy. And I see that all in this D. Granted, we can always get better, you know what I mean? Finishing off in the second half, we not scoring points. But, I mean, we doing what we supposed to do.
You're winning.
In that clock.
You're winning.
Winning them yards, John. Absolutely. Everybody has something they need to work on. That's maybe something that we know we need to do. Come playoffs, we need to make sure that we're scoring, you know, going into the second half and everything. Like, because looking at the schedule, again, it's the NFL. Anything happens at any time. Injuries can derail it. But looking at that schedule, man, it's looking like lunch meat, bro. It's looking like lunch meat.
And not only did the Eagles win, but you and David won the week. How'd that feel, bro?
Yes, sir. By the time I win something, in my ass, shit.
Yes, you and David won the week. And so now, what was your take as far as the rest of this week? As far as the rest of yesterday, I mean, I'm sorry.
Again, I'm gonna stay close. Shout out to the Giants. Like, what's going on over there, Big Blue? Like,
bruh, hey. Big Blue is saying, y'all don't believe in us yet?
I gotta watch them. I really thought it was over again. I thought it was same old Saquon. You know, he had looked like he had got injured, but it showed that he was about to go away from here. And they come back and they just like kick them out. Like, what is Lamar Johnson doing? I'm gonna tell you what he's doing. He's messing his bread up.
You mean Lamar Jackson?
Yeah, Lamar Jackson. That's what I said.
Like, you said Lamar Johnson.
John, I did?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, scratch that part.
But no, but point well taken. Yeah, right now, he is fucking his money up.
He's fucking his money up. Like, you need to go ahead and you got to do a better job. Like, that's a play you throw that away, man. Don't throw that in the traffic like that, man. He's looking like he's messing himself up. It looks like they're going to either franchise tag him or let him, but they ain't letting him go because ain't nothing out there. And they don't look like they want to pay him because he ain't showing nothing as of right now. So he needs to do better on that. The Buffalo Bills and the Chiefs, man, was that a game. Always a game with them two.
Hey, man. I mean, really. Bro, but listen. Vaughn Miller. Niggas better start putting some respect on my guy's name. This is why they got him. Because he's a closer.
It's funny. Yeah, it's funny how they paid him that money to everybody, like, for a 30-plus-year-old D.
But you see why.
And you see why. He's showing you why. And you got to think, like, these times that's going on nowadays with all this healthy eating and all this medicine and this up-to-date shit, like, these boys lasted a little bit longer in this field.
Yeah, because he still gets off the ball quicker than anybody in football. Yeah.
If they want to, if they take care of their body, they last a little bit longer. So, I mean, he looking like he's rejuvenated, he's fresh.
He looking like we should have never traded his ass. That's what he looking like. Okay, yeah. That's what he looking like. He looking like he should still be wearing a Denver Bronco uniform, okay?
But sometimes it takes a change of scenery to get that out of you too, though. So, you know, it may, or different coaches and stuff like that, but you know.
Bro, let me tell you something. We traded Von Miller around week 8 of the season. Guess who led the Broncos in sacks last year?
Who's that?
Von Miller. And he ain't even play half the season with us. That's the type of season he was having for us before we traded him. Okay?
I said this. How you out of them? They didn't see anything that was going on with that.
Bro, I said this earlier. I said, y'all can sit here and say Aaron Donald is better than Von Miller all you want to. They don't have that Super Bowl ring last year if Von Miller is not on that team. Period.
I give you that.
You can tell the Rams are missing. This is not the Rams defense. Is not the same without him.
Speaking of the Rams, boy, they look boo-boo.
Don't they?
Matt Stafford, like, is the best Stafford we knew and loved because he just be throwing stuff everywhere, bro.
The only only positive that I saw yesterday from the Rams, and I know they won, is I saw you tried to get Allen Robinson in the game. Mm-hmm. Because the problem with Matt Stafford is all you want to throw to is Cooper Kupp.
Cooper Kupp. Like, if you look at that team, boy, like, Cooper Kupp gets everything. He's doing reverse sweeps, quick screens. And, like, every time you see him, it's just Cooper Kupp, Cooper Kupp, Cooper Kupp, Cooper Kupp. I'm like, goodness gracious. Like, all I got to do is take him out and then y'all look like ass.
Exactly. Because, like, bro, right. if I'm a notable wide receiver and I'm on the market, bro, what do I want to come to the Rams for? So I can watch Cooper Kupp get 20 passes thrown his way while I get fucking 3?
Exactly. You gotta spread that ball.
That's why they're gonna move heaven and earth to get Odell back. Cause you're not gonna do that with Odell on the team.
Yeah, Odell ain't gonna let that happen.
No. Odell doesn't have to be the focal point, but I guarantee you, like, everybody named Mama know if Odell stays healthy, he would have been the Super Bowl MVP.
Yeah, he was the focal point when he got there, and not Cooper Kupp. Cooper Kupp was like the secondary when OBJ was there. You see it in the playoffs. You just throwing it straight to him.
Yeah.
I mean, but yeah, I'm not dealing with that.
But how about the New York Jets? You talked about the Giants. How about the Jets? You picked the Jets. You picked the Jets. You did. You picked them.
I picked them because, first of all, The Packers, man, they just a shell of themselves. And as I was talking to you the other day before, you know, when we got was talking about it just looked like a change in times. Like, they made the GOATs no more. Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, it's like, if you look around the league, everybody's fast and moving. Like, if you ain't a mobile quarterback, man,
right,
for the most part, you get smacked, you know?
Right.
That's sitting in the pocket. Peyton Manning and stuff like that ain't working no more. Look around the league. Look at who they talk about as the top quarterback. Everybody got wheels on them. They just roll, but everybody can make plays with their feet too. So it's a new age, bro. And them GOATs is not looking like they GOATing no more because these people getting in that backfield quicker. And if you can't move and get out of that zone and extend plays for the most part or do something fancy in there, but you get smacked, you know?
Yeah, you're getting smacked.
Got no receivers, right? They lost Cobb, and he looked like he gone for the season.
Is that confirmed? He's gone for the season?
No, I said it's looking like I ain't followed back up on that yet because I ain't heard nothing from it as I've been watching anything on that. But they gonna need some. If they lose him, that's even worse. All they got is old buddy Lazard. Is that what his name is?
Lazard and Aaron Dobbs.
Lazard and Aaron, the man who.
I mean, Romeo Dobbs, I'm sorry.
Yeah, so, I mean, they need receivers, and their defense ain't doing what they're supposed to do. They looking bad over there, so I'm like, and the Vikings.
Yeah.
Talking about we ain't play nobody. The Vikings beating everybody else ass except what we did to them, right?
Right.
Only LA got. So I don't even want to hear that. The Vikings looking good.
And I'm looking at the NFC. You know, I said this earlier that it's realistic to say that the NFC East could probably send 3 teams to the playoffs because you look at Philly 6-0, the Giants 5-1, Dallas 4-2. Everybody else in the NFC, with the exception of the Vikings, who are 5-1, everybody else of note is 3-3. Tampa, the Rams, the 49ers, the Cardinals, the Seahawks, the Falcons, even though the Seahawks and the Falcons are way better than any of us could have imagined, they're 3-3 on the upswing.
Good old Geno.
Oh,
yeah. Who knew Geno would be looking this good, looking better than,
yeah, looking better than Russell Wilson. You can say it. I know. I know. Hey, look, I'm a realist. I can admit it, bro. You know, right now, Pete Carroll is looking like a genius.
Yeah, super. Like, cause that man, Russ, I don't know what he cooking, but.
What he cooking right now ain't appetizing. That's for damn sure. He cooking that trash right now.
Big facts, yo. But yeah, man, it's been a surprising week to say the least. A lot of teams that people thought was going when they caught the mail big time, and that's the good thing about the league, bro. Especially about football too, bro. Any given Sunday, man, one day.
Yeah, the parity is definitely.
So the beat means a lot of fucking shit, bro. I don't want to hear nothing about nobody, bro.
And you guys get a bye week, so you guys can nurse back to health. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So okay, well, let's get in these picks.
Okay.
All right, Thursday night game, New Orleans. Oh, before I just wanted to pass some news along to you. You saw what happened with Robbie Anderson, how Steve Wilkes kicked him out the game, right?
Mm-hmm.
The Panthers have traded him. He got traded to the Cardinals.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know if you knew that or not.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I seen him get traded to the Cardinals.
Okay.
Hollywood, too, didn't it?
Huh?
They lost Hollywood. He out for the season.
Oh, Hollywood's out for the year?
Yeah.
Well, that's why they traded for him. But D-Hop comes back this week, too.
Yeah, from suspension. So that should change the dynamic of the Cardinals for real.
Well, honestly, to me, the dynamic won't get changed until you get Cliff Kingsbury to fuck up out of there. That's just me. But no. New Orleans is at Arizona, the aforementioned Arizona Cardinals. New Orleans at Arizona. Who you got?
New Orleans at Arizona. You know me. D-Hop come back that game, don't it?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. D-Hop come back.
Yeah, I think that gave him a spark. I'm gonna go with Arizona.
Yeah, okay. And an interesting game right here. Atlanta at Cincinnati.
Ha. You know, Cincinnati came out, they got their little win, but the Falcons on some kind of hot streak, and I don't really see too much going on with the Bengals, so I'm gonna go ahead and get a Falcons in this one.
ATL shouted. Dak Prescott will be back next week. Detroit at Dallas.
Man, you know, it would be who's me to pick the Cowboys. You know what I'm saying? Because they would be upset about what we done did to them. So, you know what? Yeah, I'm going to pick the Cowboys. But I really think that the Lions
are
going to win.
Man, bro, if the Lions beat the Cowboys. Now, see, Detroit's defense is horrible. But if the Lions beat the Cowboys, yeah. I don't want to hear nothing from a Dallas fan for the rest of the fucking season.
Yeah, but Dak gonna try his best. So I'm gonna go with the Cowboys, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, yeah, I really kind of see that as an upset game. But I'm going to stick with the
Mets. Whoa, I hope you're right. Because I'm going to pick Dallas, too, out of principle.
Yeah. The Lions been upsetting me this season, too. And I really thought they was going to do something this year, but their defense can't seem to get it together.
Well, they are coming off of a bye week. I'll give them that.
Yeah, they're coming off of a bye week. And that's another thing, reason why I was thinking that Detroit's going to win, because they'll be fresh.
Yeah.
Dak will be in there. You know, you still got them nursing this L that they caught. And you know what I mean? But they'll be juiced up and they'll be mad. So that's why I think that they'll go ahead and handle their business again.
Okay. Indianapolis at Tennessee. Two teams that we both wrote off. Matt Ryan looked like prime Matt Ryan yesterday, throwing for almost 400 yards. I think we undersold the Colts right now and we oversold Jacksonville. So now all of a sudden, this is a game for first place. Indianapolis at Tennessee.
At Tennessee, I'm going to give the home team an advantage because I think that still was an aberration for Matt Ryan. He might get his SNL.
Okay. All right. Green Bay at Washington.
Green Bay at Washington. Yes. Okay. Girl, I'm on the phone. Green Bay. I can hear Jackson up here trying to take that. Here. It's a restaurant, right? Okay. I'll play with you. No, she good. Green Bay and Washington, I am going to go ahead and go with the Commanders because I really think the Packers are absolute boo-boo.
I don't know if Carson Wentz is going to play. I just want to throw that out there. Of course, it might make a difference.
That's bad for them. Shit. With his thumb. His thumb going to be out. Who they got their backup? Is the
Taylor Heineke, yeah.
Heineke and...
he's good. He's all right. He's yeah, okay.
Yeah, he's good
enough. He took him to the playoffs.
And Aaron Rodgers.
Oh, no, he didn't. It was Alex Smith. Go ahead. I'm listening.
That defensive line going to get at Aaron Rodgers, I feel like. I'm going to give it to the Commanders.
I think Chase Young might be back, too, this week. I'm not sure.
Yeah, and like I said, he was getting smacked all around last week. And yeah.
Didn't the Jets manhandle Green Bay?
They did. That's why. And the Commanders are physical. And like I said, they lost Randall Cobb, and they only got that one receiver. I believe that they can catch that win this week. And if they don't got Carson, I feel like the team will rally. Like they really love the fact that they don't have Carson anymore because nobody likes that dude. And I think that Taylor Heineke should come in and oversold it in. It's going to be another Carson with boo-hoo trap. He's going to be on the bench and out of the league somewhere or somebody else bench behind Drew Lock in Seattle or some crap like that or whatever.
Oh, Lord, behind Drew Lock, that piece of shit. Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to the Commanders over the Packers.
Okay. Tampa Bay at Carolina.
Whew. Man. Yeah, I'm going to give it to the Bucs only because, Tampa Bay, Carolina is...
They're fielding, they're taking offers for Christian McCaffrey. I think they're about to blow that whole shit up.
Yeah, I don't want him. I want Brian Burns, but I know they really ain't trying to come up off him.
You want who?
Burns.
Burns. Oh, no, they ain't letting him go.
Well, they said that he was a reporter, too. It ain't
okay.
Popping at that, because I've been looking. You know how we're looking to go ahead and swing for the fences for this year. I know Howie over there doing something. I can almost guarantee you we're going to get another trade before the deadline. I can tell you that.
Okay. That'd be a big pickup if you get Burns. He's an all pro caliber player.
I know.
Yeah. New York Giants at Jacksonville.
Man, I'm gonna go with Daniel Jones in them, man.
Oh boy, he becoming a believer in Daniel Jones.
Yeah, I think they're a little hot. Well, I think they're a little doing something. Brian Daboll got them boys playing. Doug Peterson over there doing Doug Peterson stuff. But I think the Blues got something going on. I think Saquon gonna run all over them boys.
Okay, Cleveland at Baltimore. Hey, newsflash, Baltimore fans. This is coming from me and my brother. Learn how to hold a damn lead.
I mean, seriously. Lamar got to win this, Joe. They going to talk about him, so I'm going to say the Ravens going to take this one.
Okay, the 4-2 New York Jets at my 2-4 Denver Broncos. Because we losing tonight.
I'm going to go with the Jets, bro. Hey,
nothing personal taken. I get it.
I'm going to go with them.
Robert Saleh said before the beginning of the season, I'm keeping receipts on all of y'all who talking shit about us. And them boys is out here balling.
Yeah.
We have to start looking at the AFC East as a strong division, too, because we was all ready to bury New England. Now we got Zappy. Bailey Zappy. Who looks like an all fucking pro yesterday?
I know, like old buddy over there doing this thing. What they gonna do with that boy when he come back?
Oh, Mac Jones. Hey, listen. Bill Belichick made this choice 21 years ago when Drew Bledsoe got hurt, and a man named Brady came in and ran the offense and ran it smoothly. I'll just leave it there.
Yeah, they gonna send Mac Jones somewhere because it's a quarterback needed teams out here next year. They all gonna be fighting.
And all jokes aside, because I already got a name for Bailey Zappe when he start fucking up, Bailey Crappy. That's too easy. But he's very accurate. He's a very accurate quarterback. Mm-hmm. The AFC East, you got to look at them seriously. You got Buffalo 5-1, the Jets 4-2, the Dolphins and the Patriots 3-3. Nobody has a losing record. Now, next game, Houston at Las Vegas.
Houston at Houston at Las Vegas. I am going to go with Vegas.
Going with Vegas. Did Davante Adams get it? That dude is charging Davante Adams with misdemeanor assault.
You already knew he was coming for that.
That is a cash. That is a money grab. That is ridiculous.
You already knew he was coming for them cash. When you pushed him, I said it for a fact. As soon as you pushed him, I was like, he's going to go straight to the hospital. He went to the hospital, and then he going to file police report. It's the same thing every time.
Every time.
Every time. He knew better. As soon as he did that, everybody looking for a come up.
A quick come up, right?
Yeah. Wish you'd have pushed me. I didn't. I can't move.
You've been screaming my neck and my back.
We get that lot of coal.
I want
$150,000.
And you don't even follow that with $20. Nah, bitch, I want $150,000.
I want $150,000.
Next game, Seattle at the Los Angeles Chargers.
Man,
holy Geno Smith, Batman.
I know, and the Chargers ain't playing right. So, that's a throw about. Man, this is a wild season.
Yeah, man.
I'm going to go with the Seahawks.
Talk yourself into that one, eh? Okay.
Yeah. I'm going to go with the Seahawks because Matt Stafford is poo-cop. No, you know what? Give me the Rams.
It's the Chargers, bro. Not the Rams. Oh, the Chargers.
The Chargers. Oh, yeah. Give me the Chargers, then.
Talk yourself out of that one, huh? Okay. Gotcha.
Yeah. Even though Brandon's daily poop right now. But
yeah, the Rams have a bye week this week. Kansas City at San Francisco.
Kansas City.
Okay. Awful Sunday night game, excuse me. Pittsburgh at Miami. Remember when the Dolphins were 3-0? Don't that seem like a long time ago?
That's what I said. Any given Sunday, because they won the same path as us, and then two are gone. Now look, Sammy Jane. It only takes one person. One person. I'm going to go with the Dolphins.
Okay. Monday night football game. How the hell did the Chicago Bears get on Monday night football? The Bears at the Patriots.
Man, the Patriots.
Yeah, I agree.
Yes, baby.
Okay, Sean's picks are as follows. Kiss my niece and nephew for me. Sean's picks are as follows. He has Arizona, ATL, shouty, Dallas Cowboys with a bounce back, Tennessee Titans over the Colts, the Commanders over the Packers, Tampa Bay over Carolina, the Giants over the Jags, Baltimore over Cleveland, the Jets over the Broncos, the Raiders over the Texans, the Chargers over the Seahawks, KC Mo over the 49ers, Miami over the Steelers, and the Patriots over the Bears. How's that sound, sir?
That sounds like you got it.
All right, let me switch topics. NBA starts tomorrow. What's your expectations for the NBA season?
Not a damn thing. I hate all the motherfuckers. We ain't in it. No, but I really, you know what I'm saying? I just follow teams. I'm looking to see what LaMelo do. You know,
he's hurt. He's out. I just saw he's out for his first game. He got hurt the last week.
Well, my expectation is that I'm not going to watch any basketball games. No, I'm hoping that they've been together, the Lakers, you know what I'm saying, the whole thing, for the legacy of Kobe. I'm hoping that they get it together. Westbrook is, looking like he is just destroying that thing. It's so toxic over there. They just need to go ahead and part ways. I know he's making too much money, but I'll just go ahead and drop him. Right? If he acting like that, you just need to go ahead and drop him. I hope Anthony Davis can keep his broke-by-the-ass healthy.
Exactly.
I mean, exactly. They always talking about Westbrook. They is taking a shine off of Anthony Davis. If that motherfucker can't stay healthy, he need to stay goddamn healthy so he can help LeBron do something. But we'll see. We'll see what it's going like.
Who's the most – what's the team that you're looking at that you would be most curious about?
Well, like I said, I just wanted to see. I like to see LaMelo and how they do. I want to see if he grew any. I know they got like a lot of they lost their boy because he did something. I can't remember what he did. Something illegal.
Oh, Miles Bridges. Yeah, he beat up his chick.
Yeah, Jesus. So they lost him. But I'm just, you know me, I like to watch basketball during the playoffs. Not really my thing. I'm a football guy, but I like the excitement of playoff basketball. But as it comes on TV, I just follow a little bit of the Lakers with LeBron, of course, because he's playing where Kobe is. He's messing my boy legacy up, so he need to get up out of there.
Yeah, I have no expectations of my Los Angeles Lakers, but if there's two teams that I'm really curious to see, they're actually from the Eastern Conference. I'm really interested in seeing what Brooklyn is going to look like. Ben Simmons, Kyrie, and KD have looked good in the preseason. And the Cleveland Cavaliers, now that Donovan Mitchell is over there with Jared Allen and Mobley, and Darius Garland. I'm interested in seeing what the Cavaliers are going to like, because if they gel good, they could be a problem. Yeah, and I'm curious to see how the Boston Celtics are going to react now that their coach is gone, at least for the season.
Yeah, I need to follow up on that. I was following the interview, Joker Joe. That's wild, Joe.
Yeah, man.
That's wild. What's the outcome of that? That thing got real solid.
He's suspended for the whole year. Honestly, if I'm Ime Udoka, I'm just going to quit, because really the Celtics are trying to publicly castrate you. I guarantee, I'm not even trying to be funny or racist. If that was Brad Stevens, they wouldn't have did him. They wouldn't have did him like that. You know, they wouldn't have made it as public as it was. I just don't believe that.
But what I've seen with that situation, just from what I've been looking at, because I tried to follow a little bit, he basically smashed... who was his name? Danny Ainge's friend's, like,
A vice president of the team's wife, right?
No, it wasn't a vice president of the team. Well, she was the type that just did, you know, the tickets and everything like that. And basically, like, Danny Ainge got her the job. So she's basically a friend of Danny Ainge's. So my assumption is that, you know, like, Danny Ainge's friend, you know, some upscale, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, it embarrassed him that, you know, Udoka just popped his, you know, daughter or son-in-law's girl. You know what I'm saying? And that probably put a rift in between them and like, yo, you got to do something. And they like, what you want me to do? That's my coach. I need him.
But, and it was a consensual relationship.
That's what I'm saying. But because it made them look bad, like that family look bad, like that's his friend that made his family look bad. So now they like, yo, you need to do something. You know what I'm saying? Or we ain't going to be friends. Well, I can suspend him for a year. That's what I can do. And they trying to mess him, make him look good. Like, I just think that he smashed somebody that he shouldn't have smashed. You know how that goes.
Yeah.
And they trying to make an example out of him, but, you know.
I mean, look, and by no means is Ime Udoka innocent. I will tell these brothers, when you get in this position, you know, now I'm not going to say NBA like NFL. NBA has plenty of black coaches. Hiring black head coaches in the NBA ain't a problem. But I'm going to say this. I mean, before you tell a chick to twerk it, make sure it's worth it. That's all I'm going to say.
Don't stop.
I mean, for real.
But he be alright, man. He'll get another job, but he just need to. They just go. He just need to play Trey Songz. Mr. Studio Girl. There he go. He's a man. He's taking it.
Yeah, man. That's all I'm gonna say. So I'm interested to see how the Celtics are gonna react. Now that they don't have their coach. You're talking about a coach that just took them to the finals. Oh yeah, I never asked you about this. What you think about Draymond? Draymond Tyson. I mean, Draymond Green.
Yo, you feel me like that? We fighting every day, bro.
Bruh.
Every day, bro.
Let the church say amen.
Every day, it's on site, bro. So you gonna have to get up off the team, or I'm gonna have to get up off the team.
Bro, on site. Bro, I'm waiting at your car. You swing on me like that and it go viral, so that video is forever.
Yeah! Yo, like, you
out
here with memes. Like, 2K got updated and they got memes with his eye black on the 2K character.
What?
Yeah, brother.
Are you serious?
I was dead out there. They got a new update. It is Jordan Poole with a black. Yo, like, I got gotta fight you every day, bro.
Bro, that's why the Warriors just gave him that $140 million extension. They feel bad about that shit.
That's the money. We got to fight every day.
Every day, bro.
Every day until one of us, like, you just like, bro, man, I'm sorry for just hitting me like that. Nah, we fighting every
day. Every day, bro.
Every day. You better move, nigga.
Like when we in the layup line, nigga, I'm going to punch the shit out your ass.
Just out of nowhere, it's just going to be random shit. I'm just going to come out of nowhere. And then we just going to start fighting. Like, you might, everybody going to be like, yo, you cool today? Yeah, man, cool. We cool, man. Nah, you know, that was just a misunderstanding the last couple of days. It's going to be a couple of days. You might be chilling, you know. And out of nowhere, while you're in the lunch line, I'm just going to fight your ass with
you. Not the lunch line.
Why are you waiting to get your shit in the cafeteria? I'm just going to come out and I'm going to sock your ass. Everywhere we can do, we going to be in the goddamn with the coach. You think it's all good, you're going to be answering the question. I'm just going to come out off the desk and sock your ass.
You will be walking to your car. Next thing you know, I'm just going to come out of nowhere. I'm going to come from out of a sewer and I'm going to snuff your ass.
Sock your ass. Like, he dead ass hit that. But it was like he invited his chin to get socked. So, but still, we got to fight every day.
But, bro, you can tell the people who are not used to getting into fights. Because, bro, you're going to come and lay your shoulder, your chin on my shoulder like you're trying to big boy me. For starters, bro, Sean, where we came from, the way we grew up, nigga, if you get that close, my hands is up, bro.
Yeah, bro. Like, he pushed him, got the necessary distance he needed, but then he just stuck his chin out there like, yeah, all right. Now you're viral for getting knocked out.
Bro, and if you watch the video, Jordan Poole pushed him, but Jordan Poole is the one who went backwards.
Yeah, bro, he like jump punched his ass. You see that shit? That shit like had a jump release to it. Like, it was like, like that mother jumped and went.
Like, how you gonna chin check the nigga then try to hold him up?
Yeah, bro, because he was like, he punched him like, you know what I'm talking about, man. Like, you know Draymond's stupid. So, you know, when he do shit, after he do it, you know, he like, damn, I should have did that. Like, right after. He like one of them Sour Patch Kids. It's just bad and then sweet. That was Draymond punched him. He was like, I'm going to hold your ass up now, boy. What I tell you? I didn't mean to do that. He hit that motherfucker clean, too, boy.
That clean, bro. All you see is this nigga knees buckle. He caught him perfect on the chin.
And nigga, wet noodle pool. He turned into a pool. Wet. And nigga splashed right down to the ground. Damn, so Draymond can't be on that team no more, bro. Because, like, I don't know what that dynamic going to be. Like, that chemistry ain't going to be no good no more, bro. And if it is, Jordan Poole the biggest bitch, and everybody going to be. Like, you playing with this nigga after he socked your ass like that? Like, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Shut up, fuck me, Draymond.
Everybody going to fuck with him about that. Everybody. Anytime Jordan Poole talks shit to anybody, they just going
to
point at Draymond.
You passed to a nigga that knocked you out. Here, baby. Here, you pass the ball. I know. I threw that bitch at your forehead right on the court. You get a free throw line, I'm just going to jump and punch your ass right in the back of the neck. We'll never be on the same team again.
When I first saw that shit, I said, damn, he really did sleep his ass.
Yeah. And you seen him just creep over there like a slick motherfucker used to do back in the day. Like,
yeah.
Like, when he had his hands down like that, that's the telltale sign that he about to right hand your ass. You about to get hit. When he walked up to you on there with that shoulder jump, with his hands low like that, first of all, he knew he didn't feel threatened, so he didn't even have to protect himself because he was down there pulling his pants up like, I'm about to stick this motherfucker.
Bro, he did that shit like we used to do in elementary school. Remember when a nigga would get mad at you, you would go shoulder to shoulder and he would walk around your ass in a circle?
Yeah, what you gonna do, man? What you gonna do? Nah, he pushed him. As soon as he pushed him, he initiated that contact. So he felt that, oh, you touched me first.
Right.
Finish your ass.
Right.
Yeah. So it's justified that I knocked your ass out because you pushed me. So he should have known when you pushed him in this exact contact, he should have knew that something was coming back his way, bro.
Look, we from Holland Springs, bro. You get in our space like that, bro, hands is coming up regardless.
Fighting immediately.
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 Bruh, I'm from Pleasant Street. I'm from Pleasant Street in New Bridge. You from Fairlawn, bruh. When you get in our space like that, bruh.
Hey, buddy.
Straight up.
Hey, buddy. When you had to do that, fights every day. Fights all the time, bud.
All day, bruh. But anyway, bro.
Goddamn, we still was cool. We ain't shoot each other like this.
Nah, we ain't do all that. But bro, when you hit a nigga like that, see, well, one, when we was kids, if you hit a nigga like that, the shit won't on camera. You just had to go by what you heard. But now everybody in the scene, that shit, like, nah, we fighting every day, bro.
You got to fight every day because now you're getting tested with your manhood. You got to fight. You got to let, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to hold my advantage. You fighting, yeah. Now it's just like, shut up, nigga, if I get Draymond. Shut your ass up before I get Draymond. Pussy. You ain't gonna do nothing when I hit you. You just gonna go down, little pussy.
Bro, I guarantee you, if Draymond gets into a fight this season, I guarantee you, I know one dude that will not come to his defense at all. Unless, only reason why he would come to his defense so he could get some sneak shots in.
Yeah, man, I'm on the other team. I'm fighting with your ass. I'm gonna hit your ass too with the.
Hey, well, bro, let me let you go, bro. Hey, bro, when I tag you, when I put this bitch on YouTube, I'm gonna put your name and just put nothing but the laughing emojis, bro. You funny as a bitch.
Nah, man, that's funny though. You shouldn't hit that man like that.
Nah, he shouldn't, bro.
That's a sock, though, bro. That's a sock, man. Motherfucking Eagles. Before I get up out of here, I just want to say, the Eagles 6-0 didn't love it that we going into the bye week. Some people back. Again, you know what it is. You know the drill. You know what I'm saying. And you know, fuck the Cowboys. And I'm about this bitch.
About this bitch.
Nigga.
Yeah.
All right,
fam. I'm gonna get at you.
All right, bro.
Yes, sir.
Yep.
You already knew that was coming. You already knew, you know, as soon as Sean get on the phone, you already know, fuck them Cowboys on deck. And you guys already know what it is. It is Prediction League Monday, and I got my homie Keese on the line as usual every Monday. Keese, what it do, homie?
What's good with you?
Them undefeated Philadelphia Eagles is what's good with me. The theme of this show and the theme of this podcast is fuck them Cowboys. How you feeling?
I'm feeling good. You know, undefeated. Feeling good.
You're feeling good. You said what?
Going into the bye, let these boys rest up.
Yeah, so you can get Lane Johnson back from that concussion.
Right.
But you're feeling good because you won the game you wanted to win, but you did absolutely horrible with picks last week, sir. You were in second place behind me. I think that slot now belongs to Marcus.
I'm gonna bounce back for sure.
Yeah, that's what they always say. So, what was your takeaway from yesterday's insanity?
Yeah, you know, all these upsets, you know. Mr. Trubisky? Should he be the starter? that's my question. And, also, the Ravens doing what the Ravens been doing all season, letting games go. And are the Jets for real?
Hey, it is a time right now to be a football fan in New York. And I'm not just talking about the Jets and the Giants. I'm talking about the state of New York, because Buffalo is in New York, too.
Yeah.
But Robert Saleh said, I'm keeping receipts on all of you bitches who keep on talking shit about us. And yeah, I mean, there are a lot of questions because to me, you know, now you have to look at the AFC East as a powerful division. When 2 weeks ago, we were still laughing. We were saying the Patriots ain't got it. The Jets are the Jets. We still laughing at them. We have to look at them as a powerful division. We have to look at the NFC South as a weak division and the NFC West.
I'm calling red flag. Hey, is the Jets really good or the Packers just ass? That's my question. I think the Packers are just really not it.
Well, it could be, you know, it could be a combination of both because, you know, the Jets, if you look at the Jets receiving core, if you look at the Jets' weapons, they have weapons across the board because they're constantly in a high draft pick. They have a very talented defense. Their receiving core is actually very, very good. You're just wondering about the coach and the quarterback. So it's kind of weird. I mean, it is. It's kind of weird because, and with Green Bay, it's clear. I mean, Green Bay, they need to, you know, Aaron Rodgers is not comfortable with his weapons. And then Randall Cobb got hurt yesterday, too. And also, you got to look at Matt LaFleur, too, because special teams has been an issue for the Packers for the last 3 years. It cost you in the playoffs last year. And then you give up block punt after block punt yesterday to the Jets. What the hell is wrong with you?
Right. I don't know. I think it's more so the Packers than the Jets. I'm still not fully on with the Jets being a decent team.
Well, in the words of Bill Parcells, sir, and I know you're a little young, but I hope you know who Bill Parcells is. You are what your record says you are. And right now, the New York Jets are 4-2.
That is crazy.
And they have won their last 3 straight games.
Yeah, that does not sound right.
Okay, so if you have questions about the Jets, which I can understand, what do you think about the Giants then?
I was already on board with the Giants before the year started. Like, I already knew they had a talented roster. It just became, is Daniel Jones the answer? So this doesn't really surprise me at all. It's just the way they're winning. Their defense is really showing up, and back-to-back weeks, they've came back from deficits in the first half. So
fourth quarter deficits. They've come back in back-to-back weeks from double digits down in the fourth quarter. I mean, nobody had them beating the Packers last week in London. Nobody had them beating the Ravens yesterday. So, and actually, I was talking to Sean last night. Yesterday was the first game where I looked at Daniel Jones and was like, okay, I see it. Because he was making some throws yesterday where I was just like, well, goddamn, I didn't know you had that in you. And, you know, I can honestly say that he was one of the main reasons why the Giants came back to beat the Ravens yesterday. I mean, Lamar Jackson turning the ball over their last 2 possessions didn't help. But what the Jets and the Giants are doing to me right now is they know their strengths and they know their weaknesses. They're not doing anything over their head. They're sticking to what they're good at. And it's winning them ball games right now. I mean, just like I said, you have to look at the AFC East as a powerful division. Obviously, the NFC East. And what I loved last night is that the Cowboys fell from 2nd to 3rd because they lost. The Giants won. Now they're 2 games behind Philly, a game behind the Giants. But if you look at how weak the NFC is, it is realistic to say that you could have 3 teams coming out of the NFC East.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, the Giants schedule, the Giants should win their next few. Like, it wouldn't surprise me if the Giants were 7-1 or 8-1 at some point. You know, Dallas plays Detroit next week. You know, I mean, we know Detroit's offense is explosive, but their defense is horrible. Their defense is terrible. So, you know, you almost have to pencil that in. Y'all have a bye week, so, you know, y'all going to be undefeated heading into week 8. And, yeah, so you, and then you look at the rest of the NFC. Other than the Vikings, other than Minnesota, who's 5-1, everybody else of note is 3-3. Tampa's 3-3. Atlanta is better than what the hell we thought. Atlanta is really better than what the hell we thought. Seattle is better than what the hell we thought, at least right now.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, there's a 3-way tie in the NFC West. The Rams are 3-3. The 49ers are 3-3. The Seahawks are 3-3. There's a tie in the NFC South. Bucks are 3-3. Falcons are 3-3. So it's like right now you're looking at, you know, you could look at easily. See 3 teams from the NFC East get in. You know, you really could. It's just confusing because it's weird because I think we all wrote, and then you go into the AFC, I think we may have overhyped Jacksonville. I know I did. we may have undersold Indianapolis and Tennessee. We wanted to write, we wanted to be done with them, but now they're sitting in the first place tie. You look at the AFC North, it's a first place tie with that. Baltimore's 3-3. Cincinnati's 3-3. Pittsburgh and Cleveland are 2-4. You know, and so it's like, it's weird. It's really weird. I mean, it's a lot, but it's a good thing because it's a lot of parity in the NFL.
Yeah. That's the perfect description of this season so far. Just weird, but fun. Weird, but fun.
Yeah, because teams that we thought were going to be in strictly rebuild mode have thus far surprised us. Again, like I said, Atlanta, Seattle, the Jets. Nobody saw this coming.
Nobody.
Nobody. And the Falcons didn't just beat the 49ers. They beat the shit out the 49ers. They did. They're a legit team. They are very legit. So, now before we get to these picks, I'm going to switch sports real quick. What did you think of that Draymond Green situation?
Never in any case you should pop on your teammates. Never in any situation. Like you were saying last week, like he wouldn't have done that to Curry. He wouldn't have did that to Thompson. We know Poole be talking this shit, but like never that. And then the fact that it was open to the world, like we all heard about the whole him and KD situation years back, but there was never a video.
No, I mean that happened during the game. Like the game where Draymond called KD a bitch. And I mean, that happened during the game, but bottom line, won't no punches thrown.
Nah. Never that. So, like you said last week, the Warriors are going to have to choose between Poole and Draymond. And they gave Poole the contract.
Yeah. Yeah. They gave Wiggins the contract, too.
That's what I'm saying. So, it looks like. I don't want to say Draymond's going to be out because I feel like they'll work it out, but like, never in a situation you put your hands on a teammate. That's how I feel about that.
I feel like Draymond has to be, you know, I mean, Draymond will be Draymond on the court, but Draymond has to really straighten up and fly right if he's going to remain in Golden State. I think this is his last year, especially now based on the contract extension for Jordan Poole and Andrew Wiggins. But if Draymond remain a Warrior, because, you know, Steph and Klay, they love him. They're going to have to win another championship, and Draymond is going to have to be an all-star again this year.
I mean, but the thing about the Warriors is, obviously, we know Draymond not the best player, but we know, like, who's the heart of that team. Mm. That's
No question.
He does the dirty work. That's like the Bulls' Dennis Rodman back in the day. That's who Draymond is for the Warriors team. So
he's the enforcer.
Right. So, and then it's not like he's been taking accountability for it. Like, it's... He hasn't really gotten a suspension or anything like that, which I feel like he should be suspended, like, a couple of games, something. But we'll see.
Well, yeah, Dub Nation definitely has some things to talk about as basketball season kicks off tomorrow with the Warriors playing the Lakers. Tomorrow, bro. All
right. Oh, talking about the Lakers, that whole Russell Westbrook situation, I seen the last game, the preseason game against the Wolves, how he was acting. Like, Westbrook is just in his own way. Like, he's not going to change the way he plays. He in his hometown, you would think, like, that would make him want to play better, do it for his hometown. Like, I heard they're going to start playing him on the bench.
Yeah, and conveniently, when you bring him off the bench, he leaves the game with a hamstring injury. Conveniently. That's all I'm going to say about that.
Yeah. But honestly, I feel like the bench is perfect for him.
Oh, I do too.
That's the Russell coming off the bench.
I do too.
Right. He got the whole offense for himself. He just like, he kind of reminds me of Melo. It took Melo a long time to accept like he's not who he is anymore. And I feel like Westbrook just hasn't done that yet. And now y'all picked up Pat Beverly. I feel like that was a nasty situation from the jump. When you know the history between him and Pat Bev, I don't know why y'all picked up Bev.
I actually love them picking up Patrick Beverly because it's going to give the Lakers a bit of an attitude. It's going to give them an attitude and be more physical. I love Patrick Beverly as a player. I really do. I do. I love that pickup because he's a guy who, you know, he got nothing to lose. And he will hold people accountable on the defensive end. Even LeBron and AD, if he's doing his job and he thinks that you're not, he's gonna tell you about it. So I love that signing. I don't have any expectations of my Los Angeles Lakers this year. I don't. I have none. I have none. I'll be on record saying quick. I think the Warriors are going to repeat. Now, if I had to choose a second team that I thought was gonna win it all, I would have to say the Clippers.
Yeah, they're really deep. If they stay healthy, they're gonna be a problem.
Yeah, yes, absolutely. But let's get these picks. I know you got things to do, sir. So
yeah,
we're starting with a Thursday night game, Week 7, New Orleans at Arizona.
Arizona game, D-Hop does.
Oh, that's right. D-Hop does come back.
I still feel like Arizona, like a good team. They need D-Hop. I'm going to go with Arizona.
Arizona need a new damn coach. That's what they need. Interesting game. Now, we're on the Sunday's game. Very interesting game here. Atlanta at Cincinnati.
That is
who?
I said that is interesting. Atlanta, Cincinnati. Cincinnati at home, I'm assuming, right?
Yeah, it's in Cincinnati.
That's tricky. I'm
going to
go Cincy, though.
Okay. Detroit at Dallas.
Dallas.
Indianapolis at Tennessee. This game is for first place in the AFC South.
All right, so we had a little confusion about this last week. But I'm going to say this again. If Jonathan Taylor plays, I have the coach. If Jonathan Taylor doesn't play...
You better pick somebody right the hell now. See, no, my listeners, I want to let you know what Keith tried to do. Okay, Keith tried to hit me up a couple days ago talking about some, if Teddy Bridgewater plays, I'm going to go with Miami. No, because when I tried to do that a couple of weeks ago, when the Saints played, who the hell did they play? The Vikings in London, I didn't know Jameis Winston wasn't going to play. And I put in the group text for all the guys in the league. I said, if Jameis doesn't play, I want to change. Can I change my pick to Minnesota? They said no. Marcus hopped on my ass and said injuries are a part of the game. Keith, yeah, they are part of the game. Okay, fair enough. Now he wants to try to do the same shit. You better pick right the hell now.
I got Tennessee.
Mm-hmm. See, you see how they be trying to play me? They mad because I'm number one in the leaderboard. See how they try to play me? Green Bay at Washington.
Green Bay.
Packers looking a little shaky. Washington's coming off of a win.
It's Carson Wentz.
Carson Wentz broke his finger, too.
Did he go play?
I don't even know, but, if he plays, does that make a difference?
Yeah.
Tampa Bay at Carolina.
That's one thing we ain't talking about. We ain't talking about Tampa Bay.
Oh, man, Tom Brady. I'm getting sick and tired of Tom Brady ass throwing these little bitch fits at everybody. Take your ass home and retire. That's why your wife left you. I got into that segment earlier. That's why your wife left you, you selfish motherfucker. Go home.
That man don't like his kids, but I'm gonna go Tampa Bay.
Hey, he gonna, when he does retire, he gonna be a miserable ass dude. He really is. The New York Giants at the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Damn. Okay, so Jacksonville lost their last two straight, right? Mm-hmm. Jacksonville at home?
It's at Jacksonville, yes.
I'm going to go upstairs.
You going with Jacksonville?
I'm going to go Jacksonville.
I don't know if I would call that an upset special, but okay, upset special. Cleveland at Baltimore.
Man, Baltimore scared me.
Hey, Rave, the Raven. Hey, hey, Baltimore, if you guys are listening, I'm going to say this again. Hold, learn how to hold a damn lead.
Right. this is a divisional game.
Yep.
I'm going to go Baltimore. They got to bounce back.
The New York Jets at my Denver Broncos.
Man, I got to see how Russell for tonight, but...
Hey, man, it don't matter. Man, look, the Jets are 4-2. They're going to be playing a 2-4 team. That's how I think Russell's going to do tonight.
I'm going to go Denver. I think y'all go... Yeah, I'm going to go y'all.
All right. At your own risk. Okay. Houston at Las Vegas.
Houston, Las Vegas. I'm going to Las Vegas.
Okay. Seattle at the Chargers.
At the Chargers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to Chargers.
Holy Geno Smith, Batman. Kansas City at San Francisco. That's a good game. Super Bowl rematch.
That is a good one.
Both teams coming off of a loss.
I'm going to go Kansas City.
KC. KC Mo. An awful Sunday night game. Pittsburgh at Miami.
I'm going to go Pittsburgh.
I don't know who I want to pick for that game. It's a terrible game, but I really don't know who I want to pick. And an even worse Monday night football game, Chicago at New England.
Why Chicago on two straight weeks?
Hey, people want to see Justin Fields, man.
No. Bailey Zappi. Monday night football.
Bailey Zappi, right? Bailey Zappi did his thing. Hey, Bailey Zappi, I wouldn't be surprised if he stays the starter. He played well.
Yeah, he definitely did. New England at home?
It's at New England, yeah.
This is a tricky one. They like equally bad.
No, New England is a lot better than the Bears, okay? But pick who you will.
I'm going to go New England.
I had you marked down for New England. If you made me change my mind, I would have screamed upset special for that one. Okay. All right, so Keese's picks are as follows. Arizona, Cincinnati, Dallas, Tennessee over Indianapolis, Green Bay over Washington, Tampa Bay and Tom Brady bitch-fitting over Carolina, Jacksonville over the Giants, Baltimore over Cleveland, Denver over the Jets, the Raiders over the Texans, the Chargers over the Seahawks, Kansas City over San Francisco, Pittsburgh over Miami, and New England over the Bears. Does that sound about right, sir?
Yeah.
All right. Well, my man, I know you got stuff to do. Any parting shots?
Man, watch y'all beat Denver. Watch y'all beat San Diego. I saw almost at San Diego. Watch y'all beat Los Angeles tonight.
Oh, I would love it if we beat Los Angeles. But I have no faith in our offense right now. I have no faith. None whatsoever. Now, one good thing I will say, Justin Simmons is coming back for our defense. But, I mean, I don't want to get into my Broncos right now, okay? They really have pissed me off this season. They really have. But anyway, little bro, I'm going to get at you, okay?
We got to talk more about the NBA season. I want to know your rankings and everything.
Ah, the NBA season. Well, okay. Well, quickly, I would say in the West, I would have Golden State number one, defending champs. The Clippers number two. I have the Clippers number two. I have to look at Phoenix, even though I know, you know, with all the stuff that happened with the owner, Phoenix is kind of in turmoil because I know a lot of those players don't want to play there now. Matter of fact, I have Denver over Phoenix. I'll have Denver number three over Phoenix. Jamal Murray coming back, Michael Porter Jr. with the sack of potatoes that keeps winning MVPs. I can't think of his name right now.
What? Jokic, bro.
Oh, the Joker. Yeah, the Joker. Jokic.
I'm a Nuggets fan, but chill on my guy.
Well, I mean, he can ball. He just looks like a sack of potatoes. He can ball.
Down, bro.
No, I'm serious. I would have Denver over Phoenix. Look out for the Pelicans. If Zion Williamson stays healthy, I think the Pelicans will be a problem. I do. I think the Pelicans will be a big problem if Zion can stay healthy. Zion's another sack of potatoes. He's just a sack of potatoes who can jump really high.
Right.
Yeah.
I wish we had more time to talk about it. We could definitely chop it up about this.
Yeah, because in the East, I'm Milwaukee, Brooklyn. I'm interested to see what Cleveland does now that they got Donovan Mitchell. But, yeah, we'll talk. We'll get into it.
That season came quick. That thing started tomorrow?
Yeah. Opening, yeah. Uh-huh. Tomorrow.
And we got the World Cup next month, right? Soccer, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. So many sports.
So many sports. Baseball is in the playoffs. Everything. We're in the meat and potatoes of the football season. October is a wonderful month for sports, man.
Yeah.
So, anyway, I'm going to get at you, little bro.
For sure.
All right. Take your time, bro.
Hey, go on.
Lil Bro Keese, happy man, happy fan, happy Eagles fan. But next up, you know, he ain't been on the podcast in a minute because I have so many callers and I have dad stuff I have to do. But I usually give him the whole platform on Sports Plus Life Talking Ish. But he is on the podcast today. Tony, what it do?
Yo, what's up? What's up?
Oh, you know, I have done so much cowboy trashing today, sir. Floor is yours. What is your assessment of last night's game?
Well, first of all, you probably should have saved some of that trash for the trash that's going to hit this field tonight named Russell Wilson.
Well, hey, I don't disagree with you. He's playing like dog doo-doo.
But we'll move on. So my assessment last night is I'm happy that Cooper Rush held the ground. That was going to be a tough game for him to win in Philly anyway. There was some officiating stuff. There was some coaching bonehead, like not challenging. A clear first down. There were some bonehead individual plays, like jumping off sides on fourth and six. And
Dante Fowler.
Yeah, you got him on third. You got him third and eight. And Michael Parsons makes a hell of a play down the field, you know, linebacker on tight end, but jawjacking. And then they get the 15-yard personal foul, unsportsmanlike conduct, which results in first down, which results in a Philly score.
I'm over that with the officials, too. Okay.
So, you know, those three things influence the game when we, you know, particularly the Michael Parsons, when we add momentum coming back in the game. So those are things that'll kill you. And you can't make those mistakes when you're playing with a backup quarterback. You just can't. Because you're already under the gun. And so, you know, overall, it was what... Oh, and Dan Quinn, you know, he's a really, really, really good defensive coordinator, but he didn't adjust last night. Because even Collinsworth, and I hate Chris Collinsworth calling out the strategy they were using against Micah Parsons. You know, just kept running guys his particular, not running the ball his particular direction, but sending like A.J. Brown over there out of the backfield into the flat, you understand, and asking a linebacker to cover most wide receivers is going to be a chore. Not sure why the adjustment wasn't made if somebody just simply shadow a cornerback, you know, normal cornerback just shadowing him through the backfield area, but, you know, it wasn't. So it is what it is. So that is, but we will see them again. We get back next week for what, you know, for what it's worth, but we will, we'll see them again. We'll see them in Dallas.
Christmas Eve, if I'm not mistaken. Christmas Eve.
I expect kind of a different result because the middle of that field was wide open yesterday. Yet nothing was really going that way. When Cooper Rush did go that way, the passes was late, and they were being contested. It basically was like a jump ball situation. You can't do that against dudes like Slade. You can't.
No, Philly has the best defensive backfield in football.
You cannot just sit. You can't do that. So, you know. Like I said, it's a backup quarterback. So I temper my expectations. Cooper Rush held down the fort. And last night was going to be a tough game for him to win.
Now, you made a comment to me before we went on wax that I said I would rebuttal to when you said if Dak plays, we probably win that game. And I'm not saying this for pure – I just want to make this clear. I'm not saying this as being a Cowboys troll or a Cowboys hater. I would say this about any team, I don't necessarily agree with that because you make your game plan based on who is going to be on the field. You know, Philadelphia knew that Cooper Rush was going to be on the field. I'm pretty sure that if Dak was on the field, the game plan would have totally been different. So I can't sit here and say, just like as if Patrick Mahomes...
Was their game plan different than last week? No. They literally played Arizona the exact same way. So Kyler Murray is an athletic quarterback. They would have played Dak the same way they played Kyler Murray because they're similar. Kyler's
track. Right, but you're not playing Kyler Murray the same way you're playing Cooper Rush. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah, of course. Of course that. But what I'm saying also is, again, with Dak, some of those throws that Cooper could not make, Dak would have made.
No, I don't disagree. I don't disagree with that.
Aspect of Cooper doesn't run, Dak will take off and run.
Right, but that's why I think schematically the defense would have been a little different if you knew Dak Prescott was gonna play. I guarantee you that when y'all play again on Christmas Eve, it's gonna be a totally different defensive scheme. Well, maybe not totally different, but there will be things that are done different because you're dealing with a higher caliber quarterback. Now, I get
Christmas Eve will be different because a lot of the guys that are hurt, you'll have Tyron Smith back. We'll have a full complement of receivers provided the others stay healthy.
Well, yeah, we all hope. I mean, honestly, I hope both teams have a full complement of players when they play on Christmas Eve.
So, Jason Peters, I don't know why they didn't even play him last night. He was healthy and said he could go, but they just didn't play him.
I don't know. What I said, and you know I got it in on the Cowboys, it's no surprise, you know I got it in on the Cowboys earlier, but what I did say is this, realistic now, that given the state of the NFC, that I could easily see three teams from the NFC East going to the playoffs, because you got Philly 6-0, the Giants 5-1, Dallas 4-2. Outside of the Minnesota Vikings, everybody else in the NFC of note, all are 3-3, Tampa, the Rams, the 49ers, the Cardinals, the Falcons and the Seahawks have exceeded expectations. So I could easily see three teams coming out of the NFC East. Now, what was your takeaway from the overall day in football yesterday?
Well, my picks was trash because want to play superhuman, the Jets, and all these people want to play superhuman.
Yeah.
And nobody saw what the day yesterday. Nobody saw it.
Yeah.
I made a killing in Vegas, and it was a whole lot of unhappy people in Vegas. But
oh yeah,
this is just a weird season.
Yes.
It's a weird season, but what I will say is this, and I said this last week, and I maintain this: it is my estimation that the Buffalo Bills are the current best team in the NFL still. Buffalo Bills.
I don't disagree with that. Not at all. And why they got Von Miller, right? You see that, right?
Yeah. I meant to speak on something in terms of the game last night that actually told you in preseason because I told you to watch that dude, Turpin.
Oh yeah, Turpin. I've been watching him.
Devontae Turpin. I told you that dude is nice. Now it would be nice if they incorporated him into the offense, but he's gonna break some. He's gonna be in the league for a while.
Oh yeah, I mean, you know, speed kills.
Yeah, speed kills.
I mean, to me, that's the that's the only reason why Isaiah McKenzie is still in the league.
He may get out of his way. He likely score a touchdown.
I mean, yeah. I mean, Ted Ginn Jr. stayed in the league for a dozen years because he's fast.
Exactly. Him and Cordarrelle Patterson. Yeah.
Well, Cordarrelle Patterson, he's kind of a unicorn. I mean, he's a beast. I mean, because he can play running back or receiver. But Ted Ginn Jr., he maintained 4.2, 4.3 speed his entire career, and he had to because he didn't have the greatest hands. But when you can separate, you'll take your chances.
Right, right. So, but yeah, it was just a weird week. It's been a weird season. Right now, it's hard to assess. The records are what the records are, but it's still early in the season. That's the first thing. And things teams usually do come back down to earth at some point. They start taking them L's, and then, you know, the powers that be, the talking heads, stop riding them quite as much. But overall, even though they've had some tough, had to pull out a couple tough wins and had a tough loss, it's my sense, in all three phases of the game, Buffalo is just, Buffalo is Buffalo.
Yeah, man.
And that's it, you know, because Josh Allen right now is arguably playing like the best quarterback in the league.
I mean, to me, I mean, the only team that could really mess with them is Kansas City, but that game always happens in Kansas City. I want to see what happens when Kansas City has to go to Buffalo.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, come on, now think about it. That game is always in Kansas City. The 2020 AFC Championship game in Kansas City. The regular season game last year in Kansas City. The playoff game last year in Kansas City. Yesterday in Kansas City. I want to see what happens when Patrick Mahomes has to go to Western New York.
Yeah, I think it'll be an interesting game. But, I just think Kansas City is they'll be there, but if they got to go through Buffalo, they may not be there long.
Yeah, because, you know, it is crazy because I'm looking at the conferences. I mean, looking at the divisions. Okay, right now I have to say the NFC East is head and shoulders the best because of the records right now. You got the Eagles, Giants, and Cowboys. But then now all of a sudden you got to start putting some respect on the AFC East as well. You got Buffalo 5-1. Who knew the Jets would be 4-2? The Dolphins have come back to earth, but now the Patriots have risen from the dead. You have no team with a losing record in that division. But then you have divisions like the AFC North, the AFC South, the NFC North, the NFC South, the NFC West, that have just a bunch of 3-3 teams in the division. And it's just, it's weird. It's crazy. Because I was ready to be done with the Colts and the Titans, but here they come. I oversold Jacksonville because I saw what they did to the Chargers 3 weeks ago, but now they have hit they've hit a snag. They've hit the clunker button. And it's just, it's weird. It's wild. And nobody wants to believe in the New York Giants, but the New York Giants are beating teams that we had Super Bowl aspirations for. The Packers, the Ravens. And speaking of the Ravens, can you learn how to hold a fucking fourth quarter lead?
Yeah, how about that?
Right.
All you got to do is line up right. All you got to do is line up right.
Yeah, right. The Ravens should be 6-0. For all intents and purposes, the Ravens should be 6-0. If they knew how to hold a goddamn fourth quarter lead, they would be undefeated.
Yeah, yeah, you are not wrong there, sir. I don't know.
And I actually think the Ravens can mess with Buffalo too, but they can't hold a lead. And Lamar Jackson is fucking his money up, bro.
Yeah, he is. He is. This season, I don't know what to make of it just yet. Because we sitting here and we're discounting some of the old favorites. But, you know, there's still life, you know, because it's so early in the season. So, and those teams are suffering a few injuries, too. So we'll see. But right now, it's too hard to call.
It really is. You ready to give me your picks for next week, sir?
I'm going to say this. Mac Jones better be careful.
Bruh, I was just talking about this with Sean. I said 21 years ago, Bill Belichick had a quarterback get injured who was seen as his franchise quarterback. And he had a guy named Brady step in, and the rest is history. Could history be repeating itself? Because Bailey Zappi is all right.
Yeah.
His name just sucks. That's it. Everything else about his game is all right.
Let me tell you something else funny. I would not be altogether surprised if Heinicke gives the Commanders a little boost.
I wouldn't be either. And Sean just picked the Packers because of that exact. I mean, he picked the Washington to beat the Packers because of that exact reason.
Yeah, I would not be surprised to see them rally around him. But I also don't see him really making that big a difference overall in the season for him. So, you know, if I'm them, I might consider seeing what the other guy, the younger guy, can do. See what you got in him.
Who?
What's the other guy that they got?
Who, New England or Washington?
Washington.
I don't know who their third string quarterback. I don't know.
It's the third guy they drafted. I would at least try to see what I got in him, rather than just riding Heinicke out. If you're not actually gonna make no noise, I would go ahead and let Heinicke start. But if he flops these two games, I put the young guy in.
Okay.
You know, anyway, the way the NFC East is going, the season would be over for them anyway.
Oh yeah. I mean, this is a throwback to the '90s right now with the NFC East. And I'm going to say the mid to late 90s, because in the early 90s, Washington, well, you know, they were right there, won the Super Bowl and everything else. But this is mid to late 90s NFC right now. Okay, let's go. Thursday night game, New Orleans at Arizona. Now, a couple of plugins I want to put in. I actually like the way the Saints are running their offense. I thought the Bengals were going to beat them anyway. But I like the way they're doing. I think they look better with Andy Dalton. I like the way they incorporate Taysom Hill. And on the other end, you know, the Cardinals just traded for Robbie Anderson because you saw Steve Wilkes kicked him out. Yeah.
Yeah, I heard that. He got into it with the coordinator. Yeah.
And DeAndre Hopkins comes back. So, Saints at Cardinals. Who you got?
Saints.
You got the Saints? Okay.
Until Kyle get his together, it ain't gonna matter who come back.
Okay. Atlanta, an interesting game here. Atlanta, 3-3 Atlanta on the uptick, playing a 3-3 Cincinnati. We didn't think they would be 3-3, but they're coming off of a victory, a big victory. So, Atlanta at Cincinnati, who you got?
I'm going to go with the Falcons on this one.
Okay.
You know, what's going on with Cincinnati? You can't trust their O-line. You can't trust. I don't know what's going on with them, but yeah.
All that money they paid to the offensive line, and the offensive line still trash.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you know, spoiler alert for my pick. I picked Cincinnati because Cincinnati just has too much damn talent. And you've seen what their apex of talent can be. It can be a Super Bowl championship. It's just, I don't know. I mean, I'm still riding with them. I am. You know, I low-key love the Bengals. Detroit at Dallas, I already know.
Yeah. I expect them to get after Stafford. Yeah, I mean,
Stafford, you mean Jared Goff?
Yeah, Goff.
Yeah, Detroit, and plus Detroit's defense is absolutely horrible.
Yeah.
Their defense is horrible. Dallas may throw up 40 on them, being honest. Indianapolis at Tennessee. For first place.
Give me them Colts, man. Give me them Colts. I had no confidence in Tannehill with nothing, so give me the Colts.
Matt Ryan had a day yesterday too, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Green Bay at Washington.
Packers. Even with Heinicke motivated, eventually the Packers got to get right. This might be the week to do that.
Speaking of get right, Tampa Bay at Carolina.
Oh, wow. Give me the Bucks.
Ain't you tired of seeing Tom Brady cry like a bitch on the sidelines?
Yeah, but it's a lot of times it motivates them dudes. And
yeah, I know.
That's what he's supposed to do. Like,
what Tom Brady's supposed to do is take his old ass home to his wife and his kids. That's what he's supposed to do.
Well, there's that too, but you know.
New York Giants at Jacksonville.
But you do know that's going to be the story of the season. If
of course.
They're going to say whatever team knocks them out, save Tom Brady's marriage.
Of course. And that's going to be the excuse of why he brings his old dusty, rusty ass back next season. I was distracted last year. We're divorced. I'm fully clear now. Shut the fuck up. Go home. Giants at Jaguars.
Giants at Jaguars. Give me them Jaguars, man.
That's a hate pick.
Give me them Jaguars.
That's a hate pick. You know it.
That's a hate pick. how many fortunate things can you have, Giants, and pull these wins? They've had a lot. Their record is what their record is, but they've had a lot of fortunate
But you know the most dangerous team is a confident team. You're right. They have had a lot of things go their way. That builds confidence, though. The most, like the Jets and the Giants are the two most dangerous teams in the NFL right now. Right now, because they believe. They believe. And belief is something we cannot sneeze at. The Giants and the Jets are winning games nobody thought they would win. And they're getting confident. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
Because eventually confidence turns into good football. And then you can throw the luck out the door. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, well, I would say based on, you know, the way they played this season, the Jaguars kind of have a reason to be confident. They play better. They're not a gimme game anymore.
No, you're right. I don't disagree with that. But the last 2 weeks, the Jaguars have wet the bed, man. You're supposed to beat Houston last week. You shut out the Colts. I understand it's a division game. Anything can happen. These are division games. But those are two games that you got to win if you're going to arrive. You got to win those games.
Right.
Cleveland at Baltimore.
The Ravens should win this one.
Yeah. And back to Jacksonville and the Giants. Yes, Jacksonville's the more talented team. Yes. But do you know how to win yet? That's all I'm saying. Do you know how to win?
Yeah.
The New York Jets at my Denver Broncos.
J-E-T-S, Jets.
No problem. No, ain't nothing personal taken here. No problemo. Again, like I said, you're talking about a confident football team. A team that is building with every win, the Jets are getting more confident and confident and confident. That's dangerous, man. And the Jets are talented. The Jets actually are talented. Like, the Giants receiving core, to me, really ain't shit. The Jets receiving core is 100 times better than them. They're confident.
Right. So I guess they ain't trading Mims no more.
Oh, hell no. Hell no. Hell no. Houston at Las Vegas.
Raiders.
All right. Seattle at the Chargers.
I'm gonna take Seattle in that one.
Okay. All right, Kansas City at San Francisco.
Believe it or not, I'm taking San Fran there.
Okay, I'm not mad at you. They're coming off of a loss too. Only thing I say about yesterday's loss for the 49ers, again, the Falcons are better than we thought. And whenever Jimmy Garoppolo throws for 300 yards, it don't usually turn out well. That's all I'm saying.
That's why I give them a good chance against KC, because the game plan will likely be run that ball.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Or short dump off to Debo, and IU can still run the ball. Either way.
Absolutely.
Ball control.
Now, let's see. Pittsburgh at Miami. That's Sunday Night Football.
Yeah, see, now I got to go ahead and take Pittsburgh in this one. Yeah, I mean, I ain't taking Pittsburgh, but I got to take Pittsburgh in this one because, again, I'll go with you on the confidence thing there. And Miami is what Miami is right now. So, yeah, Pittsburgh.
Okay. Monday Night Football, awful. I don't know how it got scheduled, but Chicago at New England.
Patriots.
Yep. totally agree. So, Tony's picks are as follows. New Orleans, Atlanta, Dallas, the Indianapolis Colts, the Packers, the Buccaneers get right games. Jacksonville over the Giants, Baltimore over Cleveland, the Jets over my Broncos, the Raiders over the Texans, the Seahawks over the Chargers, the 49ers over the Chiefs, the Steelers over the Dolphins, and the Patriots over the Bears. That sound about right, sir?
That sounds about right.
All right, now, let's switch over. Basketball starts tomorrow.
And the Lakers media need to stop putting these old crackhead deals out there. So it's talking about the Bulls are considering DeRozan and Caruso for Westbrook and y'all first round 2027-2029 pick. Ain't nobody believing that trash. But it's nice to talk about because the season ain't started yet, right? Just make up some ish and throw it out there. That ain't happening.
Well, I don't disagree with you. I don't believe that's happening either. I do not believe that's happening either. So what are your expectations? What are your expectations from the Eastern Conference? I'll start with that for the NBA.
I mean, somebody gonna win it. that's the expectation. Right now, it literally is one of those things where I think it'll be similar to what it was last year. I think that what some people may be looking at and counting on is the moves that Cleveland make and overestimating their moves and thinking that will shift them. That may move them up one spot, but I don't see, you know, where it's going to shift them dramatically. But
I think it moves Cleveland out of the play-in tournament. I believe that.
Yeah, it does. It does.
And I just really, honestly, I wish they would do away with that shit. I really do. I'm not a fan of the play-in.
And I do believe that some teams, well, it might be one other team that exceeds a little bit, a team like Atlanta or something. What they expect it to be.
Getting now DeJounte Murray. Yeah. I think that's a good move.
Yeah. But everything else I expect to kind of stay static, shake out the same way. It really, I think it's going to come down to some of these peripheral players. The stars are going to do what the stars are going to do. But I think some of the young guys on some of these teams are going to, and a couple acquisitions will be end up being the difference maker. What team that is, I do not know.
So what is your expectation for the Western Conference?
Western Conference is wide open. Like it is wide open. It may seem like it's Warriors, but it's wide open because you got the Grizzlies. They got one more year after they felt this is provided. Homeboy can stay healthy because all that Jock, because all their things ride on him. Even though they seem to have played better as a team, as a unit without him, but the Suns, you know, I don't expect them to flop like they did last year. You would think that they would be legit. Beyond that, it's hard to say.
Here's the way I look at the Western Conference. I look at Golden State. They're the defending champions. You know, I'll give them that. I think the Clippers, honestly, I think if there's any team that comes out of the West other than the Suns, I think it's the Clippers. I talked about this earlier. I didn't put Memphis in there. I kind of forgot about them. So I do have to slide them in there. The Denver Nuggets with Murray and Porter back.
Yeah, if they're healthy, then yeah.
Denver?
Nuggets would be a fourth.
Yeah, Denver. Absolutely. I also think that you need to look out for the Pelicans if Zion can stay healthy. That's a big if. Because you're talking about a sack of potatoes who can jump really, really high.
And you may not necessarily want to, the people may not necessarily want to believe this, but there'll be a play-in team. They may end up getting a spot, Portland, if Dame is healthy.
And to me, Dame took last year off. Because right. The injury that he had, he could have came back. He took last year off because I honestly believe he probably thought he was going to be traded.
Right.
You know, but, okay, I'll be on the lookout for that. Like, I have no expectation of my Lakers. I think we'll make the playoffs, but I think we will probably be, you know, I think our ceiling is maybe a 6 seed, maybe a 5 seed, but I don't expect that much from the Lakers, but those other teams that I named, absolutely. Absolutely. I'm expecting, you know, that's where I think the West will be won. Warriors. I don't think Phoenix is going to flop either, but it's just going to be interesting, the dynamic of that team, because a lot of them dudes don't want to be there now since that situation happened with their owner.
Right.
So we'll just see. But yeah, I just wanted to pick your brain a little bit on the NBA. I know we're in full-scale NFL mode right now, but you know, and I'm not going to be totally locked into the NBA until after the football season is over. So I'll be locked in the NBA after All-Star break. But any parting shots, sir?
No. And really, yeah, nothing else is major is going on.
This is the time for sports. That's what it is. This is really the time for sports.
Yeah, because you got three things going on at one time.
Yeah, you got football, NBA season about to start. You got Major League Baseball playoffs going on. You got four things. Alabama just lost in the game of the year in college football. They lost to Tennessee 52-49 in the game. I had to DJ Saturday, so I was off from work. But I was like, damn it, I wish I had a DVR that game. The game of the year, Tennessee and Alabama, 52-49, the Volunteers win. So it's a lot of stuff going on. Not to mention, it was like 4 major fights last Saturday in boxing. I don't know if you saw Deontay Wilder sleep that motherfucker. But yeah, so a whole lot of stuff going on as far as sports. But you good though, bro?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to get at you soon. Matter of fact, I'll probably call you back tonight.
Okay.
All right, bro.
All right.
Been a minute since I said this. My man, Tony. Dropping that knowledge as usual. But you know what time it is now? It is time for the master himself to make his predictions. And they are as follows. Thursday night football, New Orleans at Arizona. Kind of waffled around this one, but I'm going with the Cardinals. I am. I think DeAndre Hopkins being back will provide some kind of a boost. They'll win this game. I think it's going to be a very good game as well. Atlanta at Cincinnati. I'm going with the Bengals, even though the Falcons are better than what we realize. Detroit at Dallas. Dallas. Detroit's offense is horrible. This may be a shootout, though. This may very well be a shootout. I know Dallas's defense is real. That Detroit offense is real, too. And they're coming off of a bye week. But I still have Dallas winning this game. I have the Titans defeating the Colts. I do have Tennessee beating the Colts. Green Bay at Washington. I'm thinking the Packers are going to bounce back. I mean, I have no confidence in the Commanders. Tampa Bay at Carolina. Tampa Bay, they'll bounce back. The Giants at Jacksonville. This was tough because may have oversold them a little bit, but I feel that they're headed in the right direction, but I'm picking the G-men to go 6-1 by beating Jacksonville. I got Baltimore over Cleveland. Cleveland yesterday was the first day that where I could say Cleveland got their ass beat. But for all those other games that they lost, the other three games that they lost, Cleveland really should have won those games. But you are what your record says you are. I'm going with the Ravens. And Ravens, again, here's the idea that's sweeping the nation. Hold a fucking fourth quarter lead. Anyway, New York Jets at my Denver Broncos. You hear all these people picking the Jets to beat my Broncos. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to pick the Broncos. I'm sorry. I got my Broncos losing tonight. My pride will not allow me to pick the Jets to beat my Broncos in Denver. It may happen, but I'm not going to pick that. I'm not going to predict it to happen. Houston at the Raiders, I'm going with Vegas. Seattle at the Chargers, I'm going with the Chargers, even though Geno Smith, what a resurrection season. The Chiefs at the 49ers, I'm going with the Chiefs begrudgingly. I think that's going to be a very good game. Pittsburgh and Miami, who do I pick? I mean, it's a terrible Sunday night game, but who do I pick? Goodness gracious. I'm going to go with momentum. I'm going to pick the Steelers to beat the Dolphins. And Monday night, Chicago at New England, I'm going with the Patriots. That's a no-brainer. So, there you have my picks. Cardinals, Bengals, Cowboys, Titans, Packers, Bucks, Giants, Ravens, Broncos, Raiders, Chargers, Chiefs, Steelers, Patriots. Okay? So with that being said, with a buzzer, with a buzzer, with a buzzer. Oh, man. Long episode today of Sports Plus Life. It is what it is, but it's been a beautiful episode. You know, I was able to get my guys on who I was able to go. Well, I mean, today, outside of missing Cud and David. But great episode. It, you know, for a while during this episode, it was pouring down raining. I mean, it was really pouring here off of Staples Mill in the Richmond, VA. But again, I hope everybody has a wonderful and blessed week. I had a busy day today, so this is kind of why I was a little late on starting the podcast. But, you know, it is what it is. I had to take care of my business, had to take care of my BI. But again, shouts out to my family. Shouts out to my black and gold family. And I hope everybody is safe. Everybody has a wonderful week. And guess what? It's your boy, Brandon Bravon Towns. Don't forget to hit that subscription button, hit that like button, and become part of the Sports Plus Life family. Okay? Once again, signing out. It's your boy, Brandon Bravon Towns. I'm out this beer. Peace. And I love you guys.